What's up, everyone? Welcome to Dunn and Drew, the sports talk radio. We need like
it's not, it's not radio, it's a podcast.
The sports talk podcast.
There we go.
Welcome to signing day 2017.
We out here in front of Sears.
We have a new segment. We always got a new segment coming up. This one is called Quack! 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 We said good one.
Oh, Jesus.
How do I kick him? How do I kick him? Hurry up!
There we go!
Take for Trevor, baby.
Jacksonville Jaguars select Trevor Lawrence.
Yeah! I never stretch.
Yeah, it might be to your disadvantage.
We going to the Super Bowl, and we going to win that bitch.
Durant for three. It's good! Kevin Durant from downtown.
It's so amazing.
We sent Boogie to LA.
Go to sleep. Go on.
It smells like spit.
Come and pussy.
No. Don't do it.
Taste the jello shot for Fireball. I said, fuck yeah.
Look at my eyes. Are they?
Welcome to the 200th episode of Dunn and Drew. We have about 15 people in this room right now, but if you guys want to make noise like there's 50 of you, that'd be great.
Let's go.
That means clap.
Where's he? Oh, damn. It's a busy house tonight.
Oh, we got a packed house here. Sounds like a Jags game. That's ugly ass boy over there. Thank you.
We actually have a tablet that says applause on it, so we should have held that up.
This is beforehand. A game show now.
All right. We will be asking questions along the way to help us out with a segment. And throughout the night, if you have any sports take you got to get off your chest, it's an open mic. So come up here, spit your sports take, and you'll be on the 200th episode. So at any point, just come up, sit down. And we'll hand you the mic.
Yes.
All right.
But thank you all for coming.
Yeah, thank you for coming. All right. Well,
all right.
It is a good crowd.
It's a camera now. I wish I could hear you low key.
Oh, but can you hear me at all?
I can hear you like this, but okay. I'm so used to hearing you in my headphones. It's like a more intimate
feel. I'll turn this way then.
That's why I'm sitting like this, so I can see you like this.
I was kind of turning this way earlier.
Yeah, yeah. Look at me. Look at me. It's Dunn and Drew, not Dunn and Audie. Or Drew and Audie. Oh, beer hitting.
Yeah. So... Randy's hooking us up with whale. What is this beer?
Manatee.
Oh, manatee. Whale. Wrong fish.
Wrong animal in the ocean.
Wrong mammal. Yes, all you can drink, all you can eat peanuts.
For us, yes.
Oh, okay. What are you, uppity? For us. All right, we get it. You're popular.
Chill, relax. I said us, not just me. But yes, we're here. We got beer, we got peanuts. 200th episode. It's a good time.
He gave us a shirt too, which is right up my alley.
I love nuts.
Yes.
This is the Drew brand right here. Drew brand. Could be my brand. We'll talk about OnlyFans later.
Yeah, sorry about that.
Yeah, it's all good. I'm grinding.
Does dad know about that?
Dad will find out about that.
Yikes.
Hopefully he's tuned out 2 hours in 2 hours in 2 hours. We'll find out.
All right, so other things that we're doing on this episode, we're going to take your voicemails. We asked you to leave a voicemail of your favorite moment in the past 199 episodes, and we're going to play it actually over the speaker for the audience. So hope you didn't cuss or say any of the words that we usually say on the podcast.
Imagine.
But that's fine because, you know, that's our thing. All right, so we're also going to do season predictions, and we're going to finish top 100. Top five, there are going to be some superstar all-pro players that'll be left off the top 100 list because it's off the dome.
Yes,
and
every year.
This happens every year. We're going to probably miss someone very good
Yeah, we are.
And I'm afraid of who you're going to leave out.
Me?
Yes.
I think if we go down to this list, I believe you have the next pick. Then I have four. You have three. I have two. So
who has more? Who has more picks?
Looks like it's you. Yeah, so it's going to be tough for you. But we are here, 200th episode, live in a restaurant. Our first time actually doing an episode in public. We've, hey, thank you, thank you. It's, let's go, you know, it's been great, you know, starting something brand new from scratch.
The intro's playing, I don't know.
Oh, the intro's
playing? Oh, I didn't even tell
you. You didn't tell me.
Okay. I was playing the intro, and he's usually wearing headphones so he can hear it, but he just kept talking. I'm like, please shut up. All right, so you
intro's,
finish your
intro's
sentence.
Going?
Yeah, finish
it's,
your sentence.
It's a monologue, so
oh, okay, here we go. Intro. Well, we did have Tom Donald. And that was a combination of Tom Brady and Tom Donald, so...
Yeah, we did. Yeah, yeah. That was, I misspoke. It was Orlando Brown. Orlando Pace, Orlando Brown, you know, tomato my pits.
We also have Tim Tebow on this list. Yeah.
And Trevor Lawrence at 50.
All right, back into it.
All right, man. This is it's a great night tonight, you know, like from 2017 and now we started this podcast. It's kind of crazy to see where we've gone, you know. It's been...
Where are we going?
From, I'm about to tell you from...
Well, we're TikTok famous now.
Yeah, we're TikTok famous now, but like it started, we were up late at night, you know, trying to match our lagging audio. We lost like our first 70 or 80 so episodes for using full length songs in our outros.
For no reason.
Got copyrighted for that. So we had to reestablish a whole new bunch of episodes after that. Started a group chat on Snapchat, which are now like a 30 best friends that got together that listen to us now. And we go on annual retreats with them. Then a couple years, we took some long ass breaks. You know, it was difficult doing a podcast with somebody that you don't live with, you know, doing it remotely. And
your bad.
And my bad. It wasn't my bad. It was kind of a mutual thing. Like, we would text each other and be like, yeah, I don't feel like doing it tonight. I'd be like, me either. All right. We'll go jerk our sticks. Can I say that? Yeah, I think we're good.
No, it's listening.
You can't hear me. But last year, 2020, pandemic comes and, you know, we start the YouTube channel, we do the videos, and I don't think we've missed a week with the podcast since...
Nah, I don't know if that's Jar or not.
You can't hear it?
But oh, your dad is over there doing,
I know he is,
doing but, videos.
But
he's a hype man.
I don't think... If we've missed a week, I don't think we've missed two consecutive weeks of a podcast since we started doing the videos April of last year. And now we live in Jacksonville together, and... You can't lie. Like, since we moved here in April, it's been pretty amazing. It's only been 4 months since we've lived here, and we've done some amazing things. And now we're live doing a podcast in front of, like, audience and fans. And this is the type of shit that I see on Twitter with, like, rappers who do a concert in front of, like, 20 people, and then they're selling out MSG. So this is cool. And cheers to 200, Drew.
Cheers to 200.
Damn, you need to take a sip of that.
I know,
that.
I do.
That shit dripping.
Oh, it's hitting the rim.
Oh, my God.
Knees.
This man is messy as hell tonight. But I just got to say, let me wrap up this intro monologue that, hey, this internet shit, you guys never know where it's going to go. But we going, and it's going to be a fun-ass fall for the next 8 months. So sit back, relax, enjoy episode 200. We going to keep drinking these beers, eating these peanuts, because we love nuts.
Yes, we do. Randy's Nuts.
And let's,
Jacksonville, Florida.
Let's get this damn episode underway.
We are the kings of the weekend.
If you don't know, since you're not wearing the headphones, I just hit the Kings of the Weekend jingle.
You got the first shout out, so let me hear it.
All right, so my shout out this week is all the listeners that we acquired from the past week that listened and loved our Jacksonville. Probably a lot of Jaguars fans.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But I will say there are a lot of TikTok listeners, TikTok people, because, oh my God, we probably accumulated 2 million TikTok views.
Yeah.
From that interview with Jackson DeVille, I think we hit a market on TikTok that had not been hit before, and that's mascots. But there are mascots on there, but like they don't know the behind the scenes
right.
of mascots.
Yeah.
So I think we hit like something that's never been hit on TikTok before, and it blew up. And if you're listening now, if you become a fan,
I hope you like what you hear in this episode, and I hope you continue to listen because we need it. Please fucking listen.
Andy says we need it. We do need it. Of course we need it. But like the last, you know, week or so that we've been pushing the past episode, it's been, you know, it's been something we haven't experienced yet.
It is funny. I'm glad that this is our next episode, because the people that found us on TikTok will listen to the next episode and be like, oh shit, these guys big time. They in a restaurant. Okay, I'll
like, oh shit, they got peanut cups of peanuts and beer and shit. They did a whole restaurant with an audience. White is college game day. But yes, the mascot episode was crazy. Like, even just sitting next to Curtis last episode, I felt like really touched by his stories, and I could feel the passion
He's just a mascot. He's not a war veteran.
I know, but I'm just saying, like, from his stories, I felt the passion that he was giving, and clearly, a lot of he said, get me the fuck out of here. Y'all can't see at home, but someone walked out, but he'll be back.
Well, you can't see at home if, we don't have any audience shots.
Our BTS guys are slacking.
Our BTS videographers are just mingling.
But I'm just saying, yeah, we did hit that niche with the mascot shit.
That what?
The niche. Oh, is it niche or niche?
I think it could be.
I'll say it later, but not right now. But yeah, man. Like this past episode we did and the fucking wrestling reaction we did. That was just such a perfect segue after the mascot.
It was 100,000 views right now on TikTok
to get more views and shit. So like,
you're welcome.
Hey, you're welcome.
But I'll get into CM Punk later.
Yeah, we will. But my shout out goes to everybody out here in the audience. So shout out to everybody in the audience here. They can't.
Let me.
Oh,
any CM Punk fans here? We got two.
Couple, three, two, three,
four.
Four, five.
Right, I appreciate that.
Taking y'all's temperature.
But yeah, shout out to everybody in this audience right now for the 200th episode. And this episode is brought to you by Randy's Nuts, of course.
Oh, yeah.
I love nuts. Drew loves nuts, other kinds, but tonight,
relax.
These are the boiled nuts we're talking about. They're not just known for these. They got a full menu with everything you can imagine.
Yes.
Yes. I personally recommend the Korean barbecue wings.
You want to say that over the mic?
Yes, I will say that over the mic
One second. I'm having the Korean barbecue peanuts, and I can probably confirm or attest to that.
I recommend the Korean barbecue wings. What are y'all eating back there, Juan? What y'all eating? Okay.
Garlic.
Sausage, pepper, and onion.
Oh, sausage, pepper, and onion. They got a whole bucket. Ask them what that bucket is.
What's in that bucket?
Oh, peanuts.
Oh, the shells. Got you. Right. But yeah, shout out Randy's Nuts. That is the sponsor of today's episode. We will see y'all next week for our regularly scheduled ads.
Thank you, Mr. Dunn, for being on your game. Yes. Angelo, you're fired.
Angelo, you brought all this equipment to do nothing.
No, he's rolling.
He's rolling. He said, let me put this shit up here and just hit record. But hey, yes, hey, Dad is in the building. Shout out to Bruce Dunn.
Randy? Should we get Randy?
Yeah, shout out Randy.
Shout out Randy.
Randy.
Round of applause for Randy's Nuts.
He's got this best nuts we've ever had. He's got this dope VIP Jag section in here. And as you guys can see, teal and gold curtains. Everything's Jags in here. So, not a Jags podcast. As you can tell from the shirt, get the merch. Loyalist.com/Dunn and Drew.
All right. What's your. You just did your shout out. Was that the members in the audience?
Yeah. Yeah. All that was a shout out.
Oh, and then ads. You did that. Wow. I'm behind.
That was together.
All right. We are now going to play and don't worry about being quiet for this because the microphone will pick it up. We're going to play voicemails that we've gathered in the last couple hours from our listeners. They're going to tell us their favorite moment in the last 199 episodes. Viewer discretion advised. Listener discretion advised. We did not screen these, so we do not know exactly what they... Is that for us?
Those for us, Randy? Oh, yeah, bring them on over.
All right. What? Yeah, he is.
Yeah. Andy is slacking. I was on a whole monologue. He had plenty of time to drink.
Oh, yes. I'm only like a couple sips in. Thank you. All right, so here goes the voicemail.
I'll do both.
After I take a couple sips.
Hey, how many? Let them know how many voicemails we got.
All right, so I'm gonna let's see how many voicemails we got. 18 voicemails.
18.
All right, so let's get through this.
Yeah, let's tell them this will be like an hour segment of voicemails. Yes,
this might be an hour.
What's up, boys? It's Stove in Columbus. I want to say congratulations on 200 episodes. It's a fucking amazing milestone. I've been with you guys on and off, much more on recently since the SoundCloud days going into my sophomore year of college. Graduated now. Went through college with you guys. It's been awesome. I don't know if I have a particular favorite moment from the 200 podcast, but the thing I love are the running inside jokes, the jaws, the guas, the fucking all of them. Tomato my biz. It makes us all feel, I think, like we're all in on a big inside joke with a bunch of different people, man.
Yeah.
I love the community you guys have built so far, and I'm excited to see where it goes. Once again, congratulations, boys. Hope you have a blast at Randy's Nuts.
I love that.
Hey, shout out Stove, man. Calls in every week, Ohio State. Yep. Love the guy.
The inside jokes are so good that we have a whole soundboard full of them.
Yes.
And there's
so many that we've had over past episodes that aren't even in here that we've just we've grown out of.
And there's more coming.
Yeah. I'm sure. My dad said he fucking does that laugh now. All right, let's keep it going. We got a lot.
Hey yo, what up? It's your boy Hunter, Crockett, Texas, Sticks, you know. Had to be real. I'm gonna leave you a voicemail. Congrats on the 200, you know.
Thank you.
It's just only the beginning for y'all. Y'all have a great future. I'm so proud of y'all to see how far y'all come. Y'all really make it Dunn and Drew into something special. I want to thank y'all for the community that y'all have built. I get to walk away from this podcast having what I believe to be lifelong friends, and I just can't thank y'all enough for that.
That's true.
Thank y'all for everything you do. Don't really have a sports take. Just wanted to drop by and give y'all some love. Peace out. Love you guys.
Like, it is true, the lifelong friends thing, like, many people within this podcast there are meetups like every month.
Yeah, there are.
Multiple.
And in the OG Snapchat group chat, I don't think you saw, but before we started recording tonight, Darian actually said like something like that. He said something like real sentimental about how the group chat is like, you know, made him happier, and he's like got all these friends now and shit. Yeah. So it is dope.
It is awesome.
And I think Hunter sent two because he said he forgot to list his like favorite moments of Dunn and Drew. So you might have two voicemails in there, but
that's fine.
Shout out Hunter, man. You a good one. We'll see you in Houston, my boy.
Hey, what's up, Dad?
Dad.
I wanted to congratulate y'all on 200 episodes. I don't really have a favorite moment because, like I said, it's Alex from Ohio, by the way.
Oh, Alex.
I've been here since episode one, so I literally, just thinking back through, I can't think of one particular moment that caught my eye because, I mean, they've all meant a lot to me because, I mean, listen to you guys for 4 years. You guys have gotten me through some tough times and stuff like that. So,
heard that.
Wanted to give a toast to you guys. So right now I'm pouring a shot of my favorite Pink Whitney. So if you guys want to join in too, and whoever's listening as well. So here's the 200 episodes and 200 more.
Hey.
Cheers, Alec.
Cheers,
Alec.
Hey, love
y'all.
Love you too.
Thanks for calling in. Hey, don't spill your shot next time we hang out in Columbus.
I fucked up. Totally forgot to leave my best memories or my favorite memories from the pod.
Yeah. Hunter back.
Still Hunter, by the way. Don't know. Sure you can tell. Should have my number safe by now.
Yeah, but, I actually don't. You going to save it?
Favorite memory. Boogie 5.
Yes.
Always going to be great. Every hung promiscuous.
Wait. What did you say, Boogie 5? Say it.
Damn. Do say I remember?
It. Ain't nobody buying a boogie, but what'd you...
Come on, boy. You know my memory fuzzy with that shit, boy. Ain't nobody buying a Boogie 5. Ain't nobody buying a Boogie 5. You buying a Boogie 5?
No, I'm not buying a Boogie 5s.
Goated. All of them. I'm talking, I always, at the end of every segment, I'm just sore from laughing. It's great.
You don't work out.
Great addition. And that sleeper is...
How are you roasting him?
I look forward to it. Forward to it every year. Can't wait to hear it in a couple weeks.
A couple weeks.
couple weeks. You that fake? You're not going to listen for a couple weeks?
I'm dead. We're going to play it while everybody's sleeping in the Houston retreat.
Are you going to play the episode?
I think the Boogie Fives thing is a lot of people's favorite because it was the first episode after we lost all our shit.
Yeah.
So it was like an iconic moment.
And it was, you know, right after Boogie Cousins signed with the Warriors.
Yeah, the Warriors.
And it was our first.
And he didn't play a single, like, minute, I don't think.
It was one of our first in-person episodes. It may have been our first. It was with Tommy. We were.
Wasn't that Hung and Promiscuous episode before that?
Which,
like, the one I showed you earlier today with Tommy? Or was that all the same episode?
All the same. We didn't do two with Tommy in my room.
I think we did.
We did not, 100%.
Okay,
We did two episodes with Tommy, but one of them was at the other place in Riverside. This one was in Ponte Vedra.
Oh, yes, yes.
The one with the spiders.
Yes, yeah. Yes, that was an iconic Twitch stream moment. I remember we had 100 people watching.
We did.
Yeah, we did.
Wow. It's actually impressive. More than we got here.
Chill. 15, we're downgrading.
On the road, and I'm trying to get a spot. Yeah.
Okay. All right. I think he called again.
Was that CJC again?
No, that was Arcadia, Florida. I think he called again.
Okay. Second voicemail.
Yo, Dunn and Drew. This is Raj calling in from St. Louis.
Okay, new guy.
This is my first time calling.
You're nice. I'm
trying not to fuck it up. But, yeah, my sports take is that Carson Wentz is going to take the Colts deep into the playoffs.
Yeah.
And he's going to silence all the haters. Also, I got a would you rather, if you guys don't mind.
Okay.
Would you rather you and your partner hate each other but have amazing sex, or love each other but have terrible sex?
Oh, okay.
I love you guys and love all that you do.
That's kind of a hard
question.
I like how
he said partner, too, being respectful to me.
Yeah. Partner. That's what he's definitely thinking about.
You think
that.
He did that?
No.
On purpose? Oh, okay.
Partner?
Partner. He would have said wife, like, if partner? if he didn't know.
Okay, I'll give you the benefit of the doubt.
Benefit of the best.
Benefit of the... Let me drink.
Let me drink.
Bar tab on Randy.
Give
I'm
me
fucked up.
Easily give me. I'd rather love my partner and have bad sex. Because sex is sex. If you come, it's okay. And I'm whispering because we're at Randy's Nuts. Even though it's called Randy's Nuts, I should be able to say that whatever the fuck I want.
Yeah, I would much rather love my partner. I don't want to hate the person I'm spending my fucking life with. So give me the love and give me the bad sex. Because even if you have bad sex, you're gonna come.
Right.
Yeah.
And
two strokes.
And even if I don't come, I'll jack off in the bathroom after we're done.
And I'll love my person.
Yes. Next one. Austin, Texas.
What up, Ben and Drew? It's Ryan calling from San Angelo, Texas.
Hey, what up,
Scott? I
just
want to say happy 200th episode. My favorite moment of all time is whenever Eric was covering the bowl game and whenever UT won against Georgia and Eric said, Longhorn Nation, we're back. Personal favorite moment of mine has not been top since. Close second with the Boogie Five, but, you know, it's whatever. Happy 200th, boys. Live it up.
A biased moment from him because he is a Texas fan.
We're back.
My business. Hey, that sounds like a moment where I was absolutely hammered saying
it definitely.
Yo, when I talk about college football, sometimes I'd be absolutely blacked on this podcast. And it's coming back next weekend. College football's back. Shout out, Scott.
Yeah,
love
shout
you.
Out Ryan Scott. He's a featured Dunn and Drew athlete.
Yes, he is coming up. And he is real because he met up with me in San Antonio and Crawfish Brian back in 2019.
Speaking of crawfish,
18?
Was that a crawfish that you ate before, before the episode?
That was my first time sucking a crawfish body out of its shell.
Tell me, you guys have never heard of this. Randy's Nuts here has a low country broil or boil, whatever
boil.
They call it.
Yeah, boil.
But because it's Randy's Nuts, his specialty is boiled peanuts.
Mm-hmm.
He makes boiled peanuts in it. So Eric has a cup of low country boiled peanuts.
with
corn on the cob, crawfish.
Sausage, crawfish, crab legs. It's got everything in here. Yeah. Oh, there's another crawfish in here. Hey, Chance.
Uh-oh.
After the pod, baby, we going round two, baby. Hey, we got another crawfish in here. I was sucking the shit out of him. I got a video, so we're going to post that after. But, man, it was crawfish. I ain't never had it. It's good, but it's a lot of work, man. Shellfish is a lot of work. I kind of just like having the meat on my plate already.
All right, next call.
I'm Ben and Drew. It's Ryan calling from San.
All right, sorry. Yes,
same one.
Next call.
Okay. The Huntsville area of Alabama. While I'm currently working out right now, I'm just thinking about my favorite daddy moment. And the one that comes to mind for me is Eric describing his one where he hit. He tried to clean it up before his girl woke up.
When he pissed the bed.
That was the funniest description of how he tried to cover it up. And kind of gross that I tried to picture that in my head, how he tried to clean it up, but it made me crack up. So,
I didn't try to cover anything up. I remember the video.
All right, well, he's not on the other line. You're talking like he's on the other line.
Because I really.
So he has bad connection. So
yeah, clearly.
We appreciate him calling in. I think he was talking about you trying to clean up the piss before your hookup woke up when you peed the bed. Is that what he's talking about?
Well, the three times that I did it, two of them were with somebody. And the first time...
The three times that I did it!
Relax. The first time I did it, she was already gone when I woke up, so I didn't even try to clean that up. The second time that it happened, the girl saw it with me, and we cleaned the bed together. So it had to be one of those two instances, but I never tried to hide it because there was never an instance where I had to. It was like the girl left or the girl saw it, and we cleaned it together, so... Maybe he's just forgetting the story, but if he likes my pee stories, I'll try to pee the bed again. Just give me a whole night of double Jameson gingers, and I will piss myself. A whole night, though. I haven't done that in quite some time, but if you do that, I'm pissing myself.
Oh, my God. Okay, good to know.
Yes. Feed me.
I won't. All right, Fort Worth, Texas. Here we go.
Hey, Andy. Hey, Eric.
Hello.
It's Bryson Luckett.
Hey. Luck.
Coming out of Houston, Texas now, not Houston, Fort Worth. Houston. And I just wanted to say I've done a pretty good job these last 199 episodes. And
I'm bad at that.
I want to congratulate you on getting a few hundred. Not many podcasts can say they do that. So my favorite moment from the past 199 episodes
damn, that's a lot.
Has to be... Bank Bang University at Thanksgiving time.
Thanksgiving time.
Episode, I think it was about two years ago now.
Yeah.
Like the Thanksgiving when COVID was normal. Or when there was no COVID. My bad. It's my sports take, my hot sports take.
Oh, God.
It's going to be the
NFL.
Cam Newton keeps his job all year and does not give it up tonight.
Ja.
Thanks again for playing my... voicemail on the pod, and I hope to see y'all in Houston in the next couple of weeks. I'm down here now.
Oh, so
y'all take care. Y'all have a good episode. Coming? Bye.
B-Luck? Is B-Luck coming?
I forgot. I totally forgot he goes to Houston University. We should fucking invite him to the whatever we do Saturday.
Yeah, invite him out.
B-Luck, we'll hit you up. We'll probably hit you up before you see this, but you're invited to it. Spank Bank University, was that was that your script or my script?
I didn't know what Spank Bang was.
It was me then.
So it was definitely you.
Hey, Drew was talking about script writing earlier, and he was like, he doesn't enjoy it. And I'm like, I like writing. I'm a promiscuous. But yeah, Spank Bang University, that shit was funny. But
so if you're new listening, we have this kind of soap opera podcast series called Hung in
Soap Opera. It's such a dirty soap opera. Well, dirty is like a very, it's a light word. It's way worse.
Yeah, it's way worse than dirty.
Yeah.
It's Hung in Promiscuous, you know, playing off the Young and Promiscuous. Oh, sorry, Young and Restless.
Yeah.
On CBS. How you know?
Oh, we're going to kiss in front of everybody.
How you know?
My mom watched that shit.
God.
Old and Beautiful and
yeah,
all that shit.
All right, so it's played off that. And it's, you know, about a daughter and a dad. They're both very vulgar. They may be in love with each other. They've probably had sex. So very dirty series. I like how you're like taking over my nuts right here.
I just wanted to try the Korean barbecue sauce because it was
trying
so,
it.
It was so
a
good
couple
on the
times.
Wings. This is one.
Oh, sorry.
Chill. You got a whole cup.
I barely dented the thing. Yeah, that'll last me a couple of days. So what are we talking about? Spank Bang.
Spank
yeah,
Bang
that was
University,
that was Spank Bang University. The daughter went to this university to learn how to be a porn star.
To learn how to fuck.
Ah, who writing that?
That's
who
writing you.
That? Me. That's
obviously
me.
You.
That's me. That's original as fuck. There, I fuck with it, Bryson. Thank you. Hey, some of the stiff.
Damn.
Why I'm stiff.
I get a piss.
Some of the stuff y'all telling me right now, I don't even remember. But when y'all tell me, I remember it. So I'm a little tipsy. But
all right,
you taking a pee break?
No, not till after the voicemails.
Thank God.
The next caller is one, and you all are dear to our hearts. But this man has been on every Dunn and Drew retreat with us. He is just, you know, I love him. I love him.
Do you have his number saved?
Yes. Duh.
Okay.
Tyler. This is Tyler McWilliams, a.k.a. Grillmaster McWilliams. Let's see what he had to say.
Let's hope you didn't, like, overhype his message.
What's up, guys? This is the Grillmaster calling in. First off, I just wanted to say congratulations on 200 episodes. It's a huge milestone. I know, you know, the last 4 years have been a grind. You know, you guys have been working your asses off, you know, and now I think it's going to start showing dividends.
Olay,
you
know, boy.
Dividends.
With you guys living together, it's been, episodes have been great, and not that they weren't great before, but I'll stop ranting. so I would say my favorite moment off the top of my head from the last 4 years, from the past 200 episodes, was episode 51 for Lost Files that we don't have in my collection of anymore.
How do you remember the number?
That episode, I believe, was the first time that I called in, and we did a 30 for 30, and I believe it was on the Jags. I can't remember. I think it was Jags Build or something. Yeah, I mean, that was the first time I talked to you guys, I believe. So, yeah, I mean, I started, you know, something really special, and I love that, you know, now we've gotten – I would say pretty close, and you guys are my brothers. I love you guys. I can't wait to see what the next 200 episodes look like. All the deals that are going to come your guys' way. Yeah, I mean, I'm proud of you guys. Love you guys. Congrats on 200. Sorry I couldn't make it down to Jackson tonight.
We don't blame you.
I gotta handle
you live in California.
But yeah, love you guys. Have a great episode. Fucking party tonight. Get wasted. Get black. And yeah, have a good time. All right, love you guys. Bye.
Tyler this McWilliams.
This is the man that did not sleep a wink on our last retreat that we did in Phoenix.
Bro, their last retreat in Phoenix, I tried to stay up all night on Saturday night because I think it was our anniversary, like our four-year anniversary. So, like, we did the passing around of the tequila bottles and all that, and I was trying to stay up all night. And Tyler was the only one who made it up with me all night. Like, we may have slept like 40 minutes before we had to wake up and go to brunch. I was dead that day. But he did that shit every single night.
Every night.
Every night. I did it one night and I was hating myself. He did it every night while we were there. And his voice was gone after.
Yeah. He left the retreat with no voice whatsoever.
But I don't think he regrets it because that was an amazing time in Phoenix. And I didn't go the previous year because of the pandemic and shit, and I lived at home, didn't want to, you know, COVID, my mother, all that shit. But this year, I went, and it was a great time, and Tyler McWilliams, he's a real one, Grillmaster God. Hunter, we're ready to put your skills to the test with him. I can't wait for a retreat with both of them. But Tyler, we love you. Can't wait to see you again. And we also can't wait to see where Dunn and Drew goes in the next 200, buddy.
All right, next one from Maryland.
Hey, Andy, congrats on 200. This Cheers. Is Casey calling from Owens Mills. I'm actually at the Guinness Brewery down here in Baltimore, about to grab a few beers myself, get tanked with you guys.
That's cool.
My favorite moments, I got two favorite moments out of all of them. The first one is from the regular podcast. It's actually not, it's a sentimental moment. It's when you guys actually stopped taking a break in between episodes for a few months, like 2 or 3 years ago. and you guys kept going. I know we all, you know, missed you guys during that break, so it's kind of nice that you guys upload all the time. There's no, like, 3 month break in between. And then I'm not going to spoil it. Obviously, you got to subscribe to the Patreon. But my favorite moment so far is when Eric wanted to work for a certain company. That's all I'm going to say. You guys know you got to subscribe to hear that stuff. My sports take, I think Georgia is going to win the SEC this year. I think they've got enough talent at quarterback that they're going to actually be better than Alabama. And they're probably going to win the SEC. I just resubscribed to the Patreon. I canceled some other subscriptions, so I'm in it for the long haul now. I'm not fake.
All right, for the long haul now.
What company did he say? He said, I joined a company.
Maybe he's doing – he can't be OnlyFans because you talk about that on the main.
Yeah.
I think Georgia's going to win.
Absolutely not. college – why am I so, like, quick with college football? Absolutely fucking not, Georgia. I think it's because we talked to somebody at the pool about Georgia today, and I was like, y'all got Clemson week one. I think Clemson's going to handle you. But I don't know what he's saying about the Patreon episode. Walked into a work.
I'm sure it's an easy explanation. He'll probably hit us up and let us know what
he meant. Hey, they always do. Like, when we're confused about what you guys are saying, you always DM us and you clear it up for us. So we appreciate that. So thank you for your call from Baltimore, Maryland. Enjoy that Guinness beer tonight. I know you'll be done by the time you hear this, but.
And cheers.
We're drinking with ya. Do it again.
Yo, what's good, guys? It's Alex. You know which one. I would call in with a sports take tonight, but it's not about that.
Oh, this is going to be a deep message.
All right, it's about you guys and how much you've grown as individuals over the past four or five years for this podcast and the community you've established. Most everyone's favorite moments in the podcast history is either going to be hung in the promiscuous or ain't nobody buying the Air Boogie 5 or EP from the Dirty for 30 tape. But mine personally is what got me hooked in the very beginning. I remember I was bored one day at the laundromat because my washer was broke.
On the mic?
And I finally decided to give you guys a chance
on someone's Twitter.
It was one of your very first episodes, like 9 or 10, if I can remember. I don't know, it's been deleted. But one of the very first segments was the Kanye March Madness bracket where you guys went round by round and broke it down.
Oh, I remember that.
Ever since, I've been hooked and I've been listening every week. But nothing will ever top the moments and memories we've shared at the Daddy's Retreats 1.0 in Fort Lauderdale, then 2 and 3.0 at Daddy's Mansion in Phoenix, Arizona. See you boys in Hawaii for Daddy's
Retreats
1.0. If you know, you know. But till then, you guys stay blessed. You know it's always love coming from my way. Cheers to Dunn and Drew episode 200 and hopefully many more. I got to get back to studying.
Of course he does. Wow. Alex is he's a man of many words, which, you know, whenever he sends a Snapchat, it's...
Oh, yeah.
It's
you
loaded.
Skip them.
I don't skip them.
Well, I had to call you out because you do. So this voicemail was good, Alex, because now Andy may appreciate you more. I know...
Eric, will you stop?
Andy be skipping my snaps, too, and it get to me sometimes. I'll be, like, right next to him. He'll be skipping
Alex knows I don't skip him because I screenshotted his one the other day. Oh, my God.
Hey, all right. Alex, I'll tell you this. Sometimes I don't give a fuck what you're talking about, but I watch because I like
Alex.
You know,
you are a brother to me. You are a brother to me now.
I didn't say you weren't a brother to Andy.
I'm so glad. and we actually have our first in studio guest from Randy's Nuts. So to grab this mic, let me just test it. Test. All right, here you go. Just tell us your name and where you're from.
And what's your take?
And then what you want to say. Yeah. Just hold the mic up to your face.
My name's Derek Bishop. I'm from Jacksonville, Florida. And it's a real quick question.
Yeah.
If you were to place one Jacksonville Jaguar player now.
I can tell he's tanked.
Tim Tebow. Yeah, dude, I'm fucking gone.
Cheers to that.
I'm fucking gone. If you were to place one Jaguar player right now to restore Tim Tebow, who would it be?
Of all time? All-time Jag? To replace Tim
just
Tebow?
Right now.
Wait.
I need to rephrase the question.
To what, Tim Tebow? To what?
Replace him?
Well, take one Jaguar player off the roster to put Tim Tebow.
To put Tebow back in.
Who would it be?
Man, we got a Tebow homer here.
I mean, why not?
I'm going to replace... I'm going to replace a gator with a gator.
Okay.
Taven Bryan.
Taven.
He liked that one. He liked that one.
Easily, right? That's too easy.
Replace Taven Bryan with Tim Tebow.
Tim Tebow.
I'm gonna take Henderson off our team.
Wait, what? Whoa.
Oh, everyone go hate me. Everyone go hate me. Boo this man! Boo this man! Boo this man!
For Tim Tebow.
He with me.
For Tim Tebow.
You asked, what you mean?
You're taking Henderson off for Tim Tebow?
But you want Tim Tebow back, right?
Not for Henderson.
Okay, what the hell are you going to ask and question me?
I didn't expect that.
Come on.
I didn't expect
Henderson.
Henderson gone, Tebow here.
I'm so glad he doesn't manage our team.
Yeah.
What are you anti-mental health?
Oh, if you guys listen to the last, 10 episodes, you'll see Andy's take on mental health. We got Simone Biles. We got Naomi Osaka.
All right, relax. All right,
cool.
I'm only saying that because Henderson ain't been in training camp, and Tebow, give me
but
Tebow.
But he's been balling, though.
Has he, though?
He has.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, what's training camp, though?
Have you not seen the episodes on Twitter, though?
I don't listen to Twitter. Give me Tebow and Over Henderson.
Henderson.
Hell yeah. We didn't even get enough of Tebow.
Yikes.
Like you said, Taven Bryan was easy. This is hard, and you're welcome for it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dad. Appreciate it.
All right. Y'all tune in for the terrible take, so you're welcome.
I'm going to go back to the bar.
thank you for the participation.
Caused a little uproar in the audience. Hey, if I get one man with me, it's a good take.
Come do it.
If everyone's against me, it's bad. If I get one, it's good. Exactly.
Skip Bayless.
Skill.
Are you choosing Taven Bryan over Tebow?
Well, that was his take. I didn't want to choose the same person. You know, that's not what we do over here. So, Henderson, gone. Henderson, gone.
T-Law.
Well, he picked Taven, so I couldn't. So, I'm assuming Taven's already gone when I pick my player. So, then I take Henderson. But, you know. But this is all hypothesis and fantasy. So relax.
I don't think the correct term is hypothesis.
It doesn't matter what the correct term is. It's not real. That's the point.
What word is he looking for? Hypothetical.
That's hypothetical.
Tomato my biz. I
hit the wrong button.
Well,
I think we're tamed.
The snap? I think I need more Jaeger. All right, back to voicemails.
Marysville, Ohio.
Casey Metals calling you right before I go ahead and go out and get tanked. Happy 200th episode, boys. Favorite memory, gotta throw it all the way back to the old 30 for 30s. With me do every single game every week.
That was rough.
One to stick in my mind. There was something about the Raiders. And
Angelo.
Coming on his back. Is that shit I don't even remember, but it's really funny. Have a good one, boys.
So his was Dirty for 30. Yeah, I stopped that because, you know, it had its run. Yeah,
you know, like I felt like it would get old after a while because we literally were doing every single game every week, so that had to be a segment that would get old really quick. And Andrew and I like to switch things.
Andrew,
Drew, Andy. Oh my god, I'm about to burp.
Like you're gonna say throw up? No,
not
just a bit.
Not throw up. I was talking too fast.
I'm about to throw up.
But yeah, 30 for 30 was a great segment. I'm glad it happened, but you know, we grew out of it. It got old. Just like
I think the true answer is the amount of work it takes to put into 30 for 30.
To think about it.
Doesn't justify the outcome. The means don't justify the. I don't fucking know.
It was just a lot. Fucking 16 games and shit.
Yeah, a lot. 17 now, so fuck that.
Yeah.
We're done.
Hey guys,
what if I told you?
Harry from the Snapchat group chat.
Speak up.
I don't think my favorite memory comes from a specific episode. I mean, I think it's just the chat. The chat might be the biggest thing to come out of the podcast. Maybe I'm wrong, but that could be a cool take. It's like my fresh end of my freshman year of college, end up in a group chat with 30 random people. The only person I kind of knew was Eric. And here we are, just graduated. I have lifelong friends, have lasted many purges, road trips with Alex and Josh Day, felt like across the country, see Tamu, see Brian.
This Holden?
Linked with Eric in Chicago. Linked with Eric in Daytona.
Yes, sir.
And Andy. But
never met Eric. That's
been special, and the fact that it keeps going at the rate that it's going, and we're all so close now, feels like it's just an inseparable group. Congrats on 200. Love you guys. See ya.
Hey, shout out Harry, man, because I know you've been busy with college. I know you're done now, but it's good to hear your voice. Harry is real.
We really been with people from high school to college, college.
Hey, I know it well. I know it well. I know you hate when people remember me from Vine.
All right.
But a lot
that's an act.
An act. I'm just saying, I'm comparing it to people watching me on Vine in like middle school and now being in college and shit. It's the same feel with this podcast because they listened right after I graduated college. So it was like 2016, and a lot of those people were in high school still, and now they're in college and graduating because we've been in it for 4 years. And that's an entire college tenure if you're on the correct track. I did a little 5, Andy did a little 10, but
yeah. 8.
But shout out, Harry. Love you. Can't wait to see you again. You up in Chicago. Hopefully we can get to another outing out there. But, hey, thanks for calling in. Love you, my boy. Harry Sillings.
Yo, Jordan Drew, what's up? It's Holden from Tamu.
Hey, there's Holden.
Calling in. I want to wish y'all a happy 200. I mean, y'all, you know how much y'all mean to me. And, you know, shout out to y'all for being consistent ever since pandemic, you know, like it's been crazy. And now you got T Law and the Jags. It's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be a movie. But I do have one little sports question for y'all. I know y'all been watching Hard Knocks. I know y'all hate on the Cowboys. Everyone's tuning in. We know. But what do y'all think of Mike and Dak's relationship, Mike McCarthy? Because I don't know. It seems kind of off to me. I am more worried for as a Cowboys fan for the season. Now that Hard Knocks is coming out, I think it's just going to put a bad mojo on our season. But love y'all. Keep it real. Happy 200.
I love Holden. He's very good at basketball. So shout out Holden for
he's
grinding.
Cute at basketball.
He's
I don't
cute.
Know about good.
No, he's good. Are you kidding me?
Yeah. I'm a little more critical because I'm nice.
You're not nice.
I miss a couple layups, but I'm
a
pretty
couple.
Nice.
All right. Well, anyway, Holden, thank you for calling.
Yes.
Love you to death.
But
you're very cute.
But yeah, you're cute. But we didn't watch last Hard Knocks, so if your question is around what happened in that one, don't know relationship between Dak and Mike McCarthy, no idea.
Nor do I care, really. But Holden, we missed the last episode. I don't know why. We just totally forgot.
We forgot.
I went to Eric Friday. I'm like, did we miss Hard Knocks? Because I couldn't remember if Tuesday was a Hard Knocks that we watched or Tuesday was a Hard Knocks that was like the second episode. So I truly did not. It's boring. Like episode one was boring.
Yo, episode one, I think you clicked through episode one. Because there were
I slept through it. I didn't click through it.
Oh, well, there was some moments that I saw on Twitter that I missed, and we watched it, and I was like, I don't remember this, but I guess I wasn't paying attention to it because it was that boring. And then we missed this past week's Hard Knocks, and we'll probably miss tomorrow's. It's not Monday. Miss next week's.
Yeah.
It's a busy week.
No, we got to catch up.
Yeah, we'll find some time, Holden. We'll text you.
Jacksonville, Florida.
Hey, Dunn and Drew. This is John Michael.
John Michael.
John
I wish
Michael.
I could be there, but
see
you know,
take.
COVID.
Yeah, his girl has COVID.
My favorite moment wasn't really from an actual episode, but since I'm part of the Discord community, which you should join, it's only $5.
Oh,
guys.
Thank you.
Come on now.
Thank you.
Was somehow convincing, not really just me, but a select of us in the Discord to have a pro wrestling chat
were really popping off recently. Fuck yeah, CM Punk's back.
Let's go!
No so hearts and sake right now. I'm so congested. But aww. I have maybe one of the hottest takes that I was thinking about over the past couple of weeks.
Is it
because
wrestling?
I can see the scenario happening.
Yeah, it is.
I think that Trevor Lawrence is going to end the 2021 season with more passing touchdowns than Patrick Mahomes. Now, this is not cap. I feel like this is a twofer and say that Patrick Mahomes is going to be on the injury list this year.
Wait, are you releasing yours?
But that is my hot take for the 2021 season. Trevor Lawrence will end up with more passing touchdowns than Patrick Mahomes
because he's hurt.
Of an injury.
Are you?
All right, guys. Hope you have a good rest of your night. Happy 200. I haven't been here for that long of a time, but I'm glad I am part of it now.
I forgot about the injury list.
Can you come up with it on
off the dome? Injury off the dome?
I mean, we do everything off the dome.
We do. I usually just bullshit that list anyway, and the shit come true. But to John Michael's point, saying that Trevor Lawrence is going to get more touchdown passes than Mahomes because he gets injured, that would be a duh, depending on like what week he got hurt.
But he's saying Trevor's going to be the passing touchdown leader in the league.
Hmm.
I don't know. I don't know about that one. But
yeah, I don't, John Michael, I don't know about that one either.
John Michael, it's been a pleasure to go through this CM Punk saga with you.
You know, we've made a lot of chats in our Discord, and this wrestling one is going to have some longevity. I didn't realize that there were so many.
I love that you're like, you're open to it.
I'm open to a lot of things.
And I wasn't expecting that.
Well, I'm open to a lot of things.
I mean, if it'll get us 100K on TikTok, I'm sure you'll be open to anything.
Hey, hockey games, baseball games, wrestling, I'm open to learning new shit. And even though I find wrestling corny, I find it also funny at the same time. And if it's funny to me, it's entertaining. And it's a lot of things that can't make me laugh. And wrestling does. Even if that's not your take, it's my preference. And I watch it for that reason. To right, laugh.
Next one.
To giggle.
Fort Worth, Texas.
Hey, guys. It's your boy, Jabron Favela, a recent Patreon member. I just joined it recently, not too long ago. First, I just wanted to say congratulations on 200 episodes. It's such a huge milestone, and I can't believe what a journey it's been. I remember first listening to this podcast back in high school when I was a junior, and now I'm entering my last semester of college. And it's fucking crazy, so congrats on you guys.
Wow. That is fucking
Anyways,
crazy.
My favorite moment from, one of my favorite moments from the podcast would have to be back in 2017. Y'all were doing your NFL preseason predictions. This was episode 21, I believe, if I'm not wrong.
21? How do you know?
And
how do people remember the number?
Y'all were talking about who's going to be the MVP of that year. And this man, Eric, said Colin Kaepernick. And that shit was so fucking funny because of the context of the situation at the time. It had been a year since Colin had started to kneel for the national anthem. And that shit had me dead because it came completely out of left field.
Well, most of his takes do.
Yeah. Congrats on the 200th episode. I'll see y'all on the Discord. Love y'all. And, yeah, have a good night, guys.
I love you, too. And another Texas guy.
This is what I was saying earlier about how people tell me shit that I don't remember at all. Like, I don't remember. Episode 21, how do you remember that?
You just be having takes, bro. You just be having takes.
I just be saying shit, huh? Colin Kaepernick MVP.
I don't remember that, actually.
No shit. 21.
Episode 21, apparently.
2017.
Run it back.
There's a Seabass calling live from SummerSlam.
Oh.
Got the SmackDown Tag Team Championships on the line right now. And I just wanted to call to thank you guys on 200 episodes.
Thank you.
I wanted to let you know that my favorite moment was any one that I was a part of. Any and every one that I was a part of. And also Richard Sherman being named number 13 a couple of years ago was fucking hilarious. Anyway, thanks guys for 200 episodes. And I'll see y'all in October.
Y'all.
All right. All right, y'all. That was fucking amazing. Very, like, reminiscing is... was a blast. We're going to get into our own top five moments of the podcast.
That was the last voicemail?
That was the last voicemail.
It would be Seabass. Yeah. Bro, he always finds moments to like make himself the center of attention.
He does, and there he is, the last one.
There he is, last one.
We're going to get in our own top five moments. I'm going to take a pee break. Eric, do you have to pee?
I don't.
Do you ever have to pee? Like, why? Do I just have a pussy
He said, better like why? yeah, sometimes I pee right, before
well, while I pee, why don't you get up and, you know, mingle.
All right, I'll mingle. Hey, Randy the GOAT, man. Hey, he come into frame. Come into-
yeah, actually, I would love to talk to him.
He busy.
He is busy. Got that apron on. This man.
All right.
I'm glad it's a good turnout for him.
Yeah, it
is. I'm glad we had a good amount of people here.
Hey, chill. There's more people coming, but.
All right, your top five. Let's start
with five. No, listen. We heard from a lot of people. They gave us their favorite moments of the podcast, but now it's time for Dunn and Drew. Well, I'm speaking in third person. First? Third? I don't know.
That's third.
Failed English.
That's third passive.
I don't care.
Oh, my God.
This is our moment now to give you our top five moments of our last 4 years.
Where's that camera? Oh.
And he answered you quick. Bruce said, don't worry about me. I'm handling the camera, man. Don't worry about me. He said, man, I do Fox, CBS. He said, don't worry about my camera. Do your podcast and shut the fuck up. All right. Top five favorite moments of the... That was probably top five right there. I'm joking. you want to go from five or you want to go from just... List them off.
You go five, I go five.
All right. My fifth is our TV news segment from when we first.
That was so here you go. Crazy.
No, I'm not. What do you mean here I go?
Because I'm used to you like.
Cutting you off?
Cooking everything I say.
So my fifth moment, favorite moment from Dunn and Drew history is when we first started Pod in 2017, we got on local news here in Jax. Boy, that was the season that the Jags went to the playoffs for the first time in a decade. First time I had season tickets. First time we started the pod, and we got on the fucking local news the first season that we started this shit. So that's definitely in my top five moments.
My number and yes, that was actually really fun. Was I nervous? I can't remember. I feel like I was fine.
I saw the video. I was looking through because we were putting together the intro, and I was looking at our old shit, and I saw our clip from the news segment. I was like, damn, we look young as shit. Like,
oh, I look very young.
Like, that was back when I used a buzz cut.
I barely had any facial hair. Yeah. You buzz cut.
It was buzz cut season.
And
I don't do a buzz cut no more. No. You remember last time I had a buzz cut? Then.
No. Yeah, then.
And but, after the pandemic, obviously, because I looked like a fucking homeless guy, but that's mine.
This is yours?
Yeah, it's mine.
Oh.
But yeah, that's my five. What's your five?
My number five is creating our NFL draft vlog from this past season when we went to Cleveland for Trevor Lawrence. That was a top – going to Cleveland and drafting Trevor Lawrence was a top trip of my life.
We haven't even
– it was like very rainy there, but I still had a blast. I saw a blast in Cleveland. I was shocked. I wasn't expecting to.
It fucked the weather. It was just like the atmosphere and the circumstances that, you know, we were going through at the time.
Yeah, obviously. If we were picking fifth, I probably wouldn't have had as fun. I probably wouldn't have gone, obviously. Yeah.
And we hadn't even been moved in together 2 weeks yet.
Yeah.
And we were already at the NFL draft this season together. And that vlog was like fucking amazing. It was 2 days.
We recorded a podcast right before then. So we were up very late.
Yeah. And it was great because there was a...
open bar.
There was an open bar.
And open food.
Open bar.
Like, open bar with anything you want.
Yeah. It wasn't like no trash food either. It was some seafood. We had po' boys. We had a lot of good food and open bar for...
It's kind of like right now.
For 12 hours at the NFL draft. So, of course, that was a great moment.
Give me your four.
My four is the Nick Kerr bit that we did. I think that was in one of the first 10 episodes that we did.
I don't even remember how that started. Where I saw that, but
yeah,
I think it may have been my friend Clay that saw it on Reddit, and I put it in. I was like, so Nick, Steve Kerr's son is Nick, right?
Yeah, Nick. Yeah, Nick.
Nick. What's
Why does
his last
it sound
name?
Like What's Kerr, his last? Kerr, right?
So Nick.
Nick Kerr.
that was literally what it sounded like.
And that was like, I think that was like one of the first pieces of content that I clipped for social media. Yes. and I screen recorded the damn podcast app and posted that
shit. We had no video.
Yeah, no video Skype, back then.
Skype was the only option.
Yeah, we used to Skype this podcast, and the Wi-Fi was trash for that. But
and his name is still Nick Kerr.
It's still Nick Kerr. We're saying Nick Kerr. That's Steve Kerr's son, everybody. In the audience.
He's like, okay, yeah. I am not saying the N-word.
What's your four? What's your four?
My four is our interview with Jackson DeVille the other week because it blew up on TikTok. How is this not in my top five? Like, people are saying this is our best interview. It's got the most views on YouTube of any of our podcast episodes.
Yeah.
It's probably going to get the most listens on Apple. Like, people are really into the mascot.
Until we blow up.
Mascot BTS. It's a thing. It might be need to be our shtick. We might need to interview
like mascots around the fucking country.
Benny the Bull, yeah. Blue, and Indy. No, fuck him forever because he's a Colts guy. All right. What's your four?
Get him in their mascot.
Or what's your three?
Get him in the mascot gear in the pod. My three is our very first Hung and Promiscuous episode.
Do you remember how that went?
Well, we have video of it. Wasn't that the episode with Tommy? Was that the first one?
No.
Well, then my number three is just Hung and Promiscuous.
Yes.
A lot of y'all called in and said that was one of y'all favorite like moments, like just Hung and, well, not even just like a specific moment of the segment, just the segment in general. And that definitely always has me dead because, you know, we have to play a role and also be very vulgar and sexual with it. And it's hilarious every time.
That it is.
Yes, it is.
What are we at? My three.
Your three. Oh.
My three is when, and I wish he would call in tonight. He said he would.
Did you reply to the DM?
It was when we did our first ever round of live calls, and we had your boy BP call in. And he called in. If for some reason, when he called in, because we're taking some calls, it usually goes, hey, where are you calling from, or what's your name? Yeah, and they say their name.
Yeah.
Right when he answered, and we said, "Hey, what's your name?" He said, "Hey, what up, it's your boy BP. You know what it is, or something like
and
that."
And he said it like, no, he said it way more subtle than that. He's like, "Yo, it's your boy BP."
Yeah, he said it like
a radio host.
He said it like we knew exactly who he was. Yeah. And this, unfortunately, is one of the episodes that got deleted from our copyright strikes. But it would be he's not answering. But he said he would call in. He must have heard our last episode because he said, my brothers, he said on August 11th, he said, my brothers, let's make the reunion happen. And he said, let's do 200. Just give me a date and time. And he hasn't been answering.
But I think he called in because someone that listened to our podcast told him about it to call in. So I think the reason that he DM'd us because his friend that put him on to that old episode heard us and told him, like, hey, they're talking about you again. I think that's what happened. But BP, we're waiting for you. We're ready to hear that voice again, see how it's changed over the past 4 years.
What you know what it is, your boy BP.
Hey, it's your boy BP. It's like his third call.
And then it was our boy David with the "All right, here we go."
Yeah,
which was part of the intro for probably a year or more.
Yeah,
he tried doing his dirty for 30 like five times, and every time he tried to go, he would say, "All right, here we go."
All right,
like five straight times. Yeah, so we just started dying, and he would not get it out. He would not be able to go because every time he said it, he had to say, "All right, here we go," and we would just die every time he did. So just our first round of live calls is in my top moments.
Yeah, I forgot all about that. Just saying, all right, here we go. He's like, yo, you good? You're going to go?
All right, here we go.
My number two is your number five, the NFL draft in Cleveland, mostly because here's why this is my number two. It was my first time going to an NFL draft, and to be able to go to your first draft and you're getting the first overall pick of it and you're getting a guy like Trevor Lawrence who beat Alabama his freshman year in college, it was just like Urban Meyer coming to the Jags. It was, you know, perfect fit. You know, just had moved to Jacksonville. We were vaccinated. Cole works for the Browns.
Humble brag.
He was able to get us tickets into the draft, the vaccinated drafts section. So everything just worked out phenomenally for that to work out. And Andy came. We did the vlog, and it was like a great experience because you guys know, your boy loves traveling to events and vlogging this shit. So you pair that with the moment that it was, Andy coming with me. We had just moved in together. It was amazing. It was probably one of my favorite vlogs to ever do. And you can see that's true, because if you go to my website, it's the fucking first video on the homepage, probably.
Never been to your website.
It's all good. There's nothing to see. But yes, that's my number two, NFL draft in Cleveland this year. Great experience. Hey, all you guys can take with you in life is your experiences. Hey, if you're buying dumb shit, chill. Go experience some shit. It'll stay in your mind forever. What's your two?
My number two is when me, you, and Tommy were at my home in Jacksonville, Riverside, and we had just watched, it was Sunday, we just watched Tiger Woods win the Masters.
After a while.
So we had a Sunday where the Masters were on. We watched Tiger, we were hungover, I think.
I don't remember this.
We watched Tiger Woods win the Masters, and then after that, we had the premiere of Game of Thrones. So we watched the premiere of Game of Thrones, the final season. That was one of the most...
That was the same weekend?
That was the best... That was the same day. We watched Tiger Woods win the Masters, and then the first episode of the final season of Game of Thrones in the same day, and then we did a podcast afterward.
That we did a podcast right after the Game of Thrones episode?
Yes.
What is my brain?
I guess you don't remember. Peace.
Hey, thank you guys for coming.
And thanks for staying. I love your Polaroid. Share the pictures with us if you are able to find us on Facebook. I'm
Randy's dad. Oh, shout out, Dad.
Shout out, Randy's dad.
Shout out, Randy's dad.
I would love to see the pictures you took. Facebook, Twitter, we're at Dunn and Drew, and everywhere.
Take care. Take care as well. Have a good evening. Enjoy your weekend. But I couldn't even remember that. I remember being at Andy's house for the Game of Thrones premiere, but I do not remember Tiger Woods winning earlier that day. And I do not remember recording a fucking podcast after the episode.
Okay, so what's your one?
My top moment of Dunn and Drew is our Bills tailgate vlog. Our first, I see the audience is hating. The audience is hating. They're hating over there. They're laughing at that. I don't think they saw the video, but for me, waking up that morning, 30 degrees, going to a playoff tailgate at home for the first time in a decade.
How you know the temperature?
I remember the whole fucking morning. It was amazing.
That's before you were drunk.
Yeah, I puked at 9:30 in the morning. Andy got kicked out of the stadium. I got into a fight and got to stay. And the game ended like 13-7 or some very low score. I don't remember the exact score, but it was very low. And I don't even remember any of the game because it was shit. I just remember how it finished with Jalen Ramsey getting a pick on Nathan Peterman, I think it was. Might have been Tyrod Taylor. I don't fucking know. But the Bills tailgate was the best moment that I can remember in Dunn and Drew history. It was the first year we started the pod, first year we going to the playoffs. And the energy was high, and I couldn't even fucking believe it. So I hope when we get another one this year, we'll see. But that was my favorite moment. Well, you trying to get in here, ugly ass boy?
All right.
We got ugly ass boy trying to get in the pod. But that's his Discord name.
All right. Sorry. What was your number one?
The Bills tailgate. Audience heard me. All right. Go ahead with your number one.
So the Bills tailgate, I want to say one thing about that.
You're embarrassed.
The vlog of the Bills tailgate is unlisted on YouTube because I don't want anyone to see how I acted.
I puked in the video.
So did I.
So? If that's what you're ashamed of, put it back up.
Anyway.
Put it back up. Put it back up. Put it back up.
All right.
He makes it public now. Hey, check out this vlog from 2017.
Forgot we had a live audience. My number one moment is, and I'm going to say it quietly because not everyone.
Quietly.
It was only us that was there. It was the retreats. It was retreats. But what comes from the retreats is kind of like it doubles into not only the retreats, but the relationships that everyone is, like Alex's and Tyler and all the people that made comments about, and Harry, everyone that made comments
Holden,
about how they've met like lifelong friends from the podcast.
Yeah.
That is easily my number one. Like having people are best friends because of the podcast.
The craziest thing about the retreats is that the group chat started from a random ass tweet and saying, hey, if you want to get into a Dunn and Drew group chat, message us. We'll throw you in it. And the fact that it turned into 20-ish people that have been able to stay friends in it for 4+ years, that's kind of rare. To get me, you, and like 18 other dudes, like college-age dudes, to like get along with each other for this long.
Well, not everyone got along.
Well, but like still, like we're still in a group chat with like 18 people. It didn't work out for everybody that was in it, but still, we still have 18 people that have been in it for 4 years. So for that to last that long, that's really special. And to be able to like coordinate and go to retreats every single year and just hang out and be like reminiscing about the pod and just be friends, it's kind of crazy how the internet works. And I mentioned that in the intro, and that's just how life is right now, just meeting people online and establishing relationships with those types of people. And that's what we've got here with Dunn and Drew. And I'm excited to bring more people into the Discord, the Patreon, and invite more people to the Snapchat group chats that we have. So yeah, that's definitely a special moment, but I didn't put that in my favorite moments just because, I don't know, I'm just kind of used to being in the group chat. So I kind of forget sometimes that what we got with those people, but I respect it.
All right, enough about us.
Ugly ass boy coming.
Ugly ass boy.
Ugly ass boy. Want to bring that ugly ass over here, boy.
Also, if you guys have any, I would like to talk to CM Punk. If you guys want to talk CM Punk at any point, come to our table and we'll talk CM Punk.
Would you blitz Tannehill right now?
Hmm.
Tannehill?
Yeah, would you blitz Tannehill?
He's saying in like one word, he's saying, will you blitz Tannehill?
Tannehill?
Yeah.
Would I?
Would anybody?
So we got someone.
What's the question?
Okay, straight up. Okay, he needs a mic. This is his second time at the microphone tonight. If you're listening at home, you might think we have only one person here because it's only been him at the mic.
Yeah, there's camera on you.
All right, check it out.
Oh, boy. Talking, yeah.
Third and forever, right?
Third and forever.
We're playing the Titans.
All right. The hypothetical.
It's like 3rd and 14, 3rd and 15, right?
We're down 30-15.
We're blitzing. We're blitzing Tannehill, right?
Tannehill.
Tannehill. What
tomato my piss.
You like that?
Yeah.
I mean, I've only listened to it ever since I've been listening to you guys, but straight up. How would you play Tannehill though on a third down? Whether it's third and 14 versus 3rd and 9, would you blitz?
Why are you asking? Bro, like I am fucking Urban Meyer.
Let's go.
I'm blitzing. I'm blitzing. If I'm playing Madden, I'm blitzing.
But
when I was playing Madden, I blitzed every fucking down.
You gotta worry. What are you doing, AJ? So I'm toasting you for a touchdown.
No, free fire.
So this whole
free fire.
This whole new defense, right? We're playing the 3-4 fucking.
Yes.
We're playing the whole new 3-4 fucking. Yes.
I'm blitzing. I'm bringing Miles Jack.
Although
I am worried about I am worried about Tannehill. You know, I am worried about him.
He's got AJ Brown, Julio,
and I think Derrick Henry been working on that catching. They're going to dump it off to him.
You think Derrick Henry's going to be?
He's not going to catch a third and long for a first down though. He's not going to catch a third and long.
You don't think Derrick Henry's going to go for.
If it's a screenplay versus the Jags, yes,
yeah,
he's going,
I think he could.
He's going
do
for
that,
a first down
for sure.
Yeah.
What made you ask this question? Are you just thinking about scenarios that will happen during the season?
I mean, why not? Yeah, absolutely.
Why not? I don't know.
I mean, like, dude,
I don't,
like they got
there's
Julio
more games
Jones,
than the Titans.
So like,
it's two games.
Okay, for the Falcons example, who are they throwing to?
Who?
Falcons?
Yeah.
Pitts.
Who are they throwing
that's
to?
Just besides Ridley
Pitts.
And Pitts.
Besides Pitts.
Ridley.
Pitts and Ridley, yeah.
So Ridley's the number one receiver.
Yes.
Yeah.
And who's the number two?
Don't know.
Yeah. I don't know.
Exactly.
What the hell are you saying?
What the fuck is that?
To be fair, they're not in our vision, so I don't really care.
Yeah. Yeah. Who gives a shit, right? Are you predicting Jags make playoffs? Is that what you're saying? That we have great competition?
God, you know what? In a perfect world, I wish we should make the playoffs, dude.
Do you think?
I've been watching them since I was fucking, like,
I guess it,
since I was a little
shit. Not the question. Do you think it all depends on how he blitz Tannehill?
Yeah. Because that's what you came here with the blitzing of Tannehill. You
know, you're right.
I know you're drunk, but come on. Like, we're trying to get a little base here. A little base of substance.
Would you blitz Tannehill, though?
Yes, I'd blitz Tannehill. I'm blitzing Tannehill. Blitz the hell out of him. All right,
blitz. Oh, yeah, boy.
What's his stats on being blitzed?
I don't know.
I don't
Let's
know.
Let's go.
I don't yes. know.
He's going to throw it interception. Is he? Does he throw picks when he's being blitzed?
Yes.
Well, I don't know the stats. I don't know where this question came from. I don't know what I would do, but I'm hoping we can get one win from our two versus the Titans.
I hate the Titans. Straight up.
We all do. We're Jags fans. I can't stand that
freaking Super Bowl champion. Ugly
ass boy said. Max Spence said, let me get a mic, boy. You've been talking too much.
Let's go, baby.
Fuck the Titans.
Let's cheer it.
Ugly boy.
Cheer it to the skies. Ugly right, boy, how you so, doing, ugly boy?
I'm good.
Yeah, probably.
I'm doing all right.
Ugly boy, Jaeger, welcome Jaeger to the pod. Up. How you doing? Thanks for the Jaeger earlier.
It's our little meetup.
Yes, you know, sir.
200th episode, got to do it big, right?
Yes, sir.
You know, I guess, not really a bold take, but I just want to get y'all guys' opinions on this, is Trevor Lawrence, can he break Justin Herbert's record that he just broke last year? Now, it was 31 touchdowns, 10 interceptions. It's a pretty damn good ratio.
Very good.
And his receiving core, I wouldn't say overall, is better than ours, but Keenan Allen, come on. I think
we're deeper. We are deeper. We got three really good ones.
Right.
You got to remember, they can throw to running backs for touchdowns.
Eckler. But on our side, you know, now we got ETN, who's a home run hitter. James Robinson proved last year, too.
My mouth.
Oh, wow.
Robinson proved last year that he can catch the ball and he can run. You know, I don't know how many receiving touchdowns he had.
Don't either, but he can catch.
Four or something like that. But he can do it. So I just want to know what you guys think about that, because they had, what, Keenan Allen and Mike Williams and then Eckler. And that was
Hunter
and that
Henry.
I think Henry was out with an ACL. Too. Yeah, I think he was out with an ACL so the whole year.
He only threw to a few people.
Yeah, three guys. Yeah. But 31 touchdowns with that is pretty impressive. However, I think we have overall more weapons than them. So what do you guys think? Because, you know, Trevor's actually even more touted than Herbert was coming out.
Yeah.
You know?
He is. He's supposedly the next Peyton Manning.
Yeah, he should be a lot better than them. So... I just want to know what you guys think about it. Personally, I think if the offensive line can keep the dirt off his jersey, that's a big question. I don't know if the Chargers' offensive line is better than ours. I couldn't tell you.
We did do a collaborative podcast where we predicted stats for Trevor Lawrence, and I don't think I had him above 30. I think I had him around like 25, 24. I think it's mostly because we have the duo of Robinson and ETN. That we're going to be running the ball a lot, but he does have a lot of weapons to throw to. But it's so hard to predict what the Jags are going to do this season because of our past. And just to go from 1-15 to having Trevor Lawrence, ETN, Marvin Jones with LaVisca and Chark, it's very hard to predict what the hell is going to happen, because I wouldn't have been able to predict Herbert having 31 touchdowns.
Absolutely
who
not.
Who predicted that?
I mean, I knew he was going to be good right off the bat, but
he's breaking records. We'll get to that later, but he's predicting Chargers win the AFC West, but it's very tough to gauge where these Trevor Lawrence stats are going to be. So I think it should be like a solid season for him, but I don't think he's going to
break the record.
I don't think he's going to get 30 touchdowns.
I mean, I get that.
Because our strong running backs are going to be.
And
like
our
key.
Offensive line is definitely better at running the ball or run blocking rather than pass blocking. I mean, come on. Jawan Taylor holds every other play.
Yeah.
Cam Robinson might not even be starting by like week 3. It's talking about that Walker Little guy.
Yeah, he's huge. This man is killing peanuts.
Quick feet.
You guys done?
Ugly ass boy, thank you.
All right.
All right.
Do we have to be out of here at 10? Because it's 10.
They're not kicking us out. We're going to keep going.
All right.
We're going all night. I got a whole mug of beer to finish. Y'all want more beer?
Flamingo shirt.
Y'all want me in the beer open? Hey.
Flamingo shirt. Cheers, hey. Flamingo shirt.
Flamingo boy.
And ugly ass boy.
Ugly ass boy.
Cheers, ugly ass boy.
If you got a drink, hold that shit up. I know that shit, oh, Coke. Okay. Hey, we Coke, cheersing, though. We cheersing. All right, we're going to get into our season predictions, who we think is going to win the division, and our Super Bowl predictions. We can do this rapid fire. We ain't got to spend too much time on this.
There ain't no time on this. AFC East.
I got Bills.
I got Bills. That's an easy one.
Yes, easy one. AFC West.
I have to go Chargers because... Okay,
we Flamingo. Have a Chargers fan in the.
Come here.
Okay,
please come on. Come here. You got to come on the mic.
He said,
after
let me
that.
Bring this. He said, "Let me bring this ass."
Oh,
up
look
here.
At him! Here it comes
that boy about a salsa to the stage. Said, "I'm a salsa to the."
You got it.
Hey. He said, "Let me tell you about these Chargers." Hey, there the mic go. What you got to say about these Chargers?
There the mic go. I'm dead.
he been waiting all night to talk about yeah, waiting all night for these Chargers. You're a Chargers fan for real, you capping?
I'm a Chargers fan for real.
Okay. You're no Jags fan?
All day, every day, Chargers since
San Diego?
Since 08.
Oh, wait. Shit.
I've been a fan of LT. LT introduced me into the game, and I was like, I got into Madden that way, and I was like, yo, he's great. Let me follow his team. His team's great. Then I ran into Tom Brady. Hate Tom Brady. Absolutely hate Tom Brady. But I respect him.
Yeah, respect him. Gotta respect him.
Without a doubt.
Freaking franchise dynasty. Yeah, that's about the time I got into the Jaguars. So, yeah. it's been a struggle for me. You've...
Mm-hmm. This man. All I'm saying is, y'all. I understand what Herbert did last year.
And it's gonna happen again.
I understand that they were in a lot of close games last year. They lost.
You said that.
Yep, they lost. Oh, Chargers were in a lot of close games, but lost. But the new coach. Things
which I'm
change.
Surprised at. Were you happy with the coaching change?
But
love it.
Oh.
But if Chargers do change for the better, I still think Chiefs are the superior team in that division. And I don't see how anyone cannot see that.
Please give us your reasoning
Mahomes,
of the Chargers.
Kelsey, Andy Reid, Eric Bella.
Why will the Chargers dethrone?
Tyreek Hill.
Why will the Chargers dethrone? Chargers. We got Chiefs fans over here.
No. Just a practical man. Practical man. Chiefs, if Chargers beat the Chiefs in the division,
we'll go 1-1.
Okay, let's
we'll go 1-1.
Herbert and Mahomes.
Obviously. We're not doing that 1-1 shit. I'm talking about like who's winning the division. It's going to be Chiefs. It's going to be Chiefs. Chargers can still make the playoffs if they don't win that
better
division.
Better defense? Chargers, right?
Yes.
Derwin James, is he
going to
stay healthy?
Derwin James is a monster. Huh? What happened?
Better defense than the Chiefs.
Oh, yeah.
The Chargers?
Without a doubt.
Bosa, Ingram. Wait, no, sorry.
Ooh. Steelers. Derwin James. And that's all we got.
And that's all I
know. Yeah.
He's going to stay healthy this year. I'm calling it right now.
Well, that's,
I'm calling it right
all
now.
Hope well, you have we to. All hope that our players are healthy. Trevor Lawrence going to stay healthy this year. He gets his ACL torn first play.
Fuck. God
chill,
damn.
Chill.
Wait a minute.
Chill.
I'm the villain.
Whoa.
I'm the villain.
All heel. Right.
Heel. You
heel.
Go for back. Heel. Go
heel.
Back.
Heel. Heel. Shin. Foot.
Heel.
Whatever.
No, you're a heel. You're a heel.
Let's reel that one back.
Hey,
it's
Flamingo
fine.
Boy, we got to get through the rest of these division picks, but I appreciate your Chargers pick. I don't agree with it. Andy does, apparently.
I do.
But
I appreciate it.
I Cheers. Will see you week 17 when the Chiefs are 14-3.
Oh, boy.
Fuck. I'm dead.
4-0 in the division. AFC North. I have the Browns winning that.
We have our resident Steelers fan here who says, boo.
Well, you're not going to like his take either. Who do you have winning? Who do you have winning the AFC North, Drew?
Ravens.
I said both.
What'd you say?
I said that y'all both would take Ravens or Browns.
Would
Ravens
either of you like to come rebuttal?
Would you? Do you have a...
Come on.
Do you have any Steelers?
I know you have some Najee Harris
blood?
Takes.
You were.
It's not even just a Najee Harris take.
It was tonight. It was tonight. We have Chance here who is all Najee Harris all night.
Not even all Najee Harris all night.
You saw a nice little rollout by Ben.
Big Ben, man. Ben so inspirational, out. Man. No, listen. We know, listen, we can admit, and we all know Ben's on his way out of the league.
Yeah.
But
yes.
Realistically.
Dwayne Haskins. Quickly.
Is it Haskins' time? Is it Haskins' time? Look at Haskins, man, so Haskins. Inspirational. Is it Haskins' time in Pittsburgh?
Who he inspiring?
Who is he inspiring?
Backups.
I like how you put it.
I'm just saying, who is he inspiring?
Is he inspiring?
That's what we ask you.
I'm asking y'all.
Is he inspiring you?
Hopefully Najee Harris.
Mason
Rudolph ain't inspiring me either.
Who quarterback in the Steelers? Who your running back?
Najee Harris?
Yeah, I know. You Najee Pro.
I'm Najee Pro.
You Najee Pro.
Najee Pro.
Listen.
You haven't said anything that's going to say anything, though.
Listen,
Steelers win the division.
Hear me out.
How you guys beating the Browns or the Ravens?
How you beating the Browns? How you beating Baker? How you beating Lamar and Mark Andrews?
Listen, man. Listen. Hear me out. Mike Tomlin.
He's a great coach.
Never a losing record.
They haven't had a below 500 record in 13 years or more.
So, hear me out, though. Every season that we've come in as the underdog, we've won the division. So,
sorry.
Nothing. What was the button?
It was a snore.
Come on now. Listen, we've continually been an underdog. We arguably have one of these best secondaries in the NFL. Think about it. Do not snore. Done? Do not snore me. Bro, come on now. You got to give Minka and Hayden.
Minka and Hayden.
They're both in our top 20. Top 20. 100.
Top 20?
Top 2100.
Top 2100. Listen, man.
Ain't no way.
I'm just ready for y'all's top five. I need to hear it.
Oh, yeah. It's coming.
Oh, Ben ain't in it.
Well, no kidding, Ben. Ben ain't in anybody's top five.
Hey, Ben. Fifth. Not happening. I'm sorry.
No, but truthfully with Pittsburgh, I feel like, you know, I've been. I continually. No, listen, seriously. I continually have to be unbiased because I'm in journalism. You know, I've got to stay away from being biased. But as a Steelers fan, I think that our offense can continue to get better. And especially even with Mason and Dwayne at 2 and 3, I still think Ben. Do not bore me. Do not see me done.
See,
whatever the hell. This is probably getting cut anyway. I'm just up here for fun. But seriously,
we'll see.
I think that this potentially could be the year we see us get past the wild card, past the Browns. I think if this is the year of the Super Bowl for Pittsburgh.
This is the year you finally get past the Browns?
The year of the Super Bowl for Pitts.
I'm just saying. Listen.
Can I have the mic back?
You can have. Listen. No. Listen. If the Super Bowl happens for Pittsburgh,
boo!
Y'all really gonna boo me?
Boo this man,
bro. There ain't even enough people in here for you to boo over top of my voice.
Why are you calling me out? I got enough boos for a damn county.
Thank you. Seriously, but listen. If the Super Bowl happens for Pittsburgh, it's this year. It's this year. If it's not this year, after that.
So you're saying your window is like almost shut.
This is the window's almost shut. Ben's career is next to over.
I agree.
It's one of those.
You're living.
You're saying Super Bowl this year, or we're in the poverty for a decade.
That's pretty much it.
You have to have this.
Hayden is about to sign into his last 2 or 3 years of his deal. This is it. This is the season for Pittsburgh to win a Super Bowl, and I don't see it happening. Y'all didn't let me get past that.
Well, I don't see it happening.
Yeah, we don't either.
Well, no kidding.
That's why we have Browns rave.
No, I told that ugly boy over there.
He's not ugly. He's not ugly.
I don't remember his name.
I hope he got Uber.
No, listen. I got my whip. I don't know what you're tripping
about. Not you. Flower boy. Flamingo boy. Shit.
Bro, listen, no, just yeah, that's my take though. Truthfully, I think this is the
hey,
one.
Hey, we
though.
Respect I mean, it. We're used to homers on this pod.
Bro, I can't stand people who are like Super Bowl stands for teams. Like it's just, you know, it just gets old.
Well, what the fuck did you just say? You just said listen, Super Bowl said, or nothing.
No, no, that's what I'm saying. It's Super Bowl or nothing. But I'm not saying that I think it's going to happen. I understand
his
that Patrick Mahomes stands between us and a ring, and Josh Allen. I mean, how do you guys feel about the Bills?
They're good. Well, we'll get to that take later.
It's them and the Chiefs. That's how I feel.
AFC Championship?
Well, we're getting to our predictions, so I don't want to get ahead of myself.
I hear you. Because I know Drew's Super Bowl prediction. I'm going to keep my mouth shut.
Yes, spoiler.
I know the spoiler. He's told me his private information.
Y'all was talking beforehand.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
I'm still waiting on yours.
Yeah,
I didn't.
Well,
I didn't
it's coming. Well, you're on this mic for 20 minutes. Well,
I'm bouncing now. Fellas.
Hey. Thank you.
Sorry,
you
got a crawfish hand, so.
I keep crawfish hands.
Okay. Lick mine up, boy.
Relax.
Yeah, I'm getting a little too comfortable with the audience.
AFC South.
AFC South, Titans in a landslide.
Titans as well.
Yeah. NFC East, I've got the Cowboys.
Cowboys.
Yeah. So if Dak doesn't play the whole season, still Cowboys?
No. I mean, I'm not going to predict injuries. Am I going to predict injuries for all these?
Well, they're saying that he may not play the whole season.
Why?
Because he's not fully recovered yet.
He's fine.
Okay.
He's fine.
Football team will win that. Shout out, Dad.
You're shaming your dad here, the football team.
Well, that nigga don't even really watch the NFL, so. NFC West, I've got the Rams winning that. Duh. What do you mean, duh? That's the toughest division this season.
It is a good division.
Rams, Cardinals, Seahawks.
Sorry, they're – okay. Yes, Rams.
Niners, yes. I got Rams. NFC North, both agree here. Packers. Cheesehead, I got one coming in the mail.
Why?
For a brand deal. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about that on the Patreon. NFC South, Bucks. Duh.
But I will say Jameis's Saints. Sleeper.
Exactly. Sleeper indeed. Davis. I don't think the Saints are going to scare anybody.
So so we're in a Jaguars themed bar.
We are.
Give me a Jaguars record official for the season.
My official Jags record for everybody in this bar, all seven of you, is 7-10.
Mr. Dunn, is this two shot squared up? What did you say?
I said Jags will be 7-10 this year, and we will not go to the playoffs.
Yikes.
But 7 wins will be good enough for Jags fan base to have faith in the next season. 7 wins is a lot for a Jags fan base that just went 1-15. So that's right. My take.
I don't know how many Jaguars fans we had in here, but I got 10-7 playoffs.
Yes, I know you do.
And
he's on that good, good.
I just pointed the mic toward the crowd for a. I just pointed the mic
nobody,
toward.
Nobody
the crowd
agreed.
For applause, and I got nothing.
Nobody agreed.
So, no one agrees. Not 10
That's
and
me.
7. 10 and 7.
7 and 10.
Randy?
Randy.
Oh, let's go.
Hey, get Randy on the pod,
Randy.
Baby. Randy on the pod.
Randy.
Let's go.
Woohoo! Randy.
Randy. Yeah, that's all.
Randy. All right.
Oh, damn. Y'all abrupt.
Y'all synchronized.
Y'all abrupt.
What's up, Peanuts.
Hey, Peanuts good. It's hey, first time I had a crawfish, sucked its brains out.
Yep.
Got a video for that. Almost choked on the corn, but I wasn't ready for that spice, but it's good.
I appreciate it.
Yeah, I said no spice, and they didn't give me what he got, so I appreciate it. Although I really wanted to try the Low Country Boil. So.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm
glad y'all enjoyed
it. It was
first
a spice.
Peanut eater?
Yeah, basically, pretty
from
much.
He never had boiled peanuts, though, he said.
Yeah, it wasn't raised. That was old time down in South Carolina. Yeah, he was raised up in there. I was raised in Daytona Beach, a little more uppity.
Suburban.
Beaches and crab legs, you know? But we're in this VIP room, Jags branded. We got the Jags curtains. We're in Jags seats all around here.
Absolutely.
Let's get your take on the Jags this season, because you've been telling us a lot about the team this year. How you think we're going to do, man? I know
It's your inaugural season, too, with your restaurant.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Honestly, I think that we can probably pull off 9 to 10 games.
Let's go. And I said, we just went through the schedule. I said, before going through the schedule, I said 10. We just went for the schedule for my first time. Mm-hmm. I said 9. So I'm literally 9 and 10.
I think so.
So
the intangibles of just games. The coach and the quarterback, the will to win, the rookie quarterback and them wanting to see him succeed. I think they probably want to play for him.
I just think we have too many offensive weapons. Like that? We have, so like our offense, I think will be through James Robinson. So we'll be a run focused team. Outside of that, we got Trevor's arm, Trevor's legs, Marvin Jones, LaVisca Chenault, DJ Chark's deep threat.
Etienne.
I know who's on the roster. I know who's on the roster. This is just like you're way too bullish on a winning season. From going from 1-15, we're not going straight to 9 wins. Have some humility. We're having a 7-win season at the most.
I don't know. You're dealing with a coach that will retire and fake heart attacks.
Oh,
you got the scoops.
he's losing. You know what I mean?
Mm.
It's about the will to win.
You think if Urban is in a losing streak, he's going to be out of here? You think he's just going to drop?
No, I think that he's not going to get in a losing streak.
Because he
doesn't want to go to the hospital no more. Point blank. I just think that with Trevor not losing, them not used to losing.
Yeah.
You know how Jalen Ramsey cried because he wasn't used to
But losing? As a corner, you have less power.
Leaders in both of those positions. You know what I mean? The will to win, the intangible.
No, I'm totally on board. I'm totally on board with
X and O's, you know, what, Billy's and Joe's? I think we got both of them. You know what I mean? We got both of them.
Well, man, I love the optimism.
The 3-4 defense we switched to, I think that suits Josh Allen and Chase on.
Yeah.
I think we got a stout up front run.
Miles Jack out there.
We held him, 1.2 yards preseason game, which, you know, it's preseason, but.
Yeah, it wasn't Nick Chubb and it wasn't.
You got Miles Jack running downhill. Then you got, Damian Wilson. This fit the scheme. You got good safety and cornerback play. I don't know about, what's your boy's name from Florida?
Henderson.
Henderson.
Yeah, I don't know, trying to get away. But we got a deep cornerback room.
We do. We're deep. We're deep.
Speed.
Was
just saying.
Yeah, I know the potential is there.
Potential
but
is there.
7 wins is where I see where we're going to be.
It's possible.
And that's not a bad prediction.
No, hell no.
I don't think 7 wins is a bad prediction.
Did you see us going 1-15?
No.
Exactly.
Exactly. 7 wins, though. 7 is good. For being 1-15, I think 7 is, good.
But did anybody see that?
We just went through the schedule.
Mm-hmm.
We went through the schedule, and I think 7 wins is a perfect number.
I think we're doing 7 to 10.
I mean,
well, that's a big range for
3
for NFL. That's a big range.
What's your favorite thing about your restaurant?
Probably the mural.
The mural,
yeah.
The right there.
You a big art guy? Art fan?
I like art, but I don't.
Is that you?
Yeah. Well, yes, a character.
Caricature of you.
A customer's daughter.
Everybody in this bar right now better take a picture of that mural, put it on IG story, tag Randy's Nuts.
Yeah. In a year's time, we want it.
We the reason we out here. You viral. Too, Flamingo Man. He said, I got you. Ugly Lad Boy, you too, man.
Hey. Is you guys close at 10. It's 10:24.
No, we're good, buddy.
We're good? All right. Yeah, we're good.
We might have another hour. Yeah, I'm just kidding.
We're good. We chill, man. So y'all do your thing.
Hey, yeah, shout out Randy, man. Thanks for hosting us.
I'm having a good time. We appreciate having y'all.
Hey, we appreciate you giving us this little space to do our podcast, man.
That's what it's for, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Episode 200. Looking forward to seeing what this restaurant got for the season, man.
Unofficial away game place to be.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean,
so y'all got to help us.
It looks nice.
For sure.
Away the
unofficial.
Home game's going to suck because everybody's there.
Yeah, yeah.
Hopefully everyone's in the stadium.
Hopefully people are there. But Randy's Nuts will be the unofficial place for away games, you know?
Right.
Like right now. Because we away at the Saints on Monday, so.
Yep.
All right, Randy. Thank you, man.
Appreciate it.
We're going to wrap.
Who's next?
Nah, just nobody. We're going to wrap this thing up. We got a lot of things to do.
Super Bowl pick.
Super Bowl predictions. I don't think anybody's beating Tom Brady in the NFC. You think someone's beating? Well, we'll get to yours. Brady's going back to the Super Bowl, and he's going to the Super Bowl against the Buffalo Bills.
This quiet ass room.
Ain't nobody said a goddamn thing.
They said the Bills. No one gave no one gave a shit about that prediction.
Bucks Bills.
Yay.
Take it to the bank.
If anything deserved this, it's this.
Okay, let's hear yours.
My prediction is the Rams. Just kidding.
Rams. Hey, the Rams. Stafford.
I just think the Matthew Stafford edition balances out their offense with the defense. And I got Rams versus Chiefs because I feel like the Chiefs are going to be there every year. Mm-hmm. And I think they'll beat the Bills.
I like that. I like that we don't have a Bucks-Chiefs rematch.
Last year, I predicted Chiefs-Bucks. Oh, thank you.
I was right. It happened.
I predicted Bucks-Chiefs before the season, and it came true. So
yeah, it did.
I'm going, what'd I say?
You said Rams.
Rams-Chiefs. Rams-Chiefs. Yeah. Rams-Chiefs.
Rams-Chiefs.
So that's my pick.
Those are our picks. We're sticking to them.
The Rams are just loaded with Stafford. I think that's the thing that put them over the top.
But I don't think they're loaded on offense, but I think Stafford – well, the Rams went 10-6 last year with Goff, so I think adding Stafford really helps them there.
All right,
but
top 100 off top 100 off the dome.
I'm trying to agree with you.
We have to go through our top 100, right?
All of them?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll do it. We'll do 10 by 10.
All right.
So
this is our top 100 NFL players off the dome. No research.
It's terrible.
All off our head.
But it's off the dome. So,
but we're doing our last five tonight here. So we have to recap. We have to recap.
Is Ben Roethlisberger?
We have to recap the entire list for you. So let's go 10 each.
I'll start. Jonnu Smith, 100. Kenny Galladay, Orlando Pace, Hall of Famer. Miles Jack, Penei Sewell, Curtis Samuel, Christian Kirksey, Darius Slay, Jarvis Landry, Tim Tebow,
Teddy Bridge.
Thank you.
Teddy Bridgewater, not one of ours. Miles Sanders, Trent Williams, Chase Edmonds, Tom Brady at 86. Chill. Hold your hate. Hunter Henry, David Njoku, Joe Hayden. Got you. Chandler Jones, J.J. Watt at 81.
Yikes. Jonathan Taylor, Tyrann Mathieu, Terry McLaurin.
He don't know that team.
He don't care.
He said, who? Who?
Minka Fitzpatrick, Danelle Hunter, Adam Thielen, Melvin Ingram, Jason Verrett, Devontae Parker, and Stephon Gilmore.
Roquan Smith, Devin White, A.J. Brown, Shaquille Griffin, Jags fan, shout out. Saquon Barkley, a little injured. James Robinson at 65. Justin Herbert.
Hey, he heard it.
Herbert at 64, baby. Derwin James, 63. Quinnen Williams, Bobby Wagner.
Geno Atkins.
He washed. That was my pick.
Lamar Jackson. Kareem Hunt. Who said Kareem Hunt? We had Kareem Hunt come, bro.
Do we?
No one.
Jordan
Poyer.
Our boy.
Oh, wow.
He bought his merch.
Darren Waller. Melvin Gordon, Chris Jones, Aaron Jones, Chris Claypool.
Is Chase.
Man. Oh, jeez.
We wrote Chris because I said Chris and I was drunk when I said it. But I don't know what I had that night, but I said Chris at first.
And Malik Hooker.
Malik Hooker, he's on the Cowboys now, but when we picked him, he was a free agent. Trevor Lawrence at 50.
Trevor Lawrence.
Allen Robinson, Zach Martin, Chris Godwin, Kyler Murray, Montez Sweat. He said who? Jamal Adams, Tre'Davious White, Von Miller, and Kyle Pitts at 41.
Hey, all right. TJ Watt.
Yeah.
40.
Right, thanks.
Shut up.
Nick Bosa. Oh, wait, no, that's Joey. Sorry.
Flamingo said, I can't hear you.
Nick Bosa, Dak Prescott, Harrison Smith, 37, Tyler Lockett, David Bakhtiari, Yannick Ngakoue, Matthew Stafford, Chris Carson, Micah Hyde.
Oh, Keenan Allen, my boy, fantasy boy. Nick Chubb, also my fantasy boy. Vita Vea, DK Metcalf at 27. Cam Hayward, Xavier Howard, Darius Leonard, Fred Warner, who? Chase Young. Shut the hell up. Laramie Tunzel at 21.
Trash.
Hey, he made NFL Network's top 100.
What was the NFL Network's top 100?
He was in like top like 70 players. 67. Well, ratio me then. I don't care. Go ahead.
Miles Garrett, Dalvin Cook, Mike Evans, Tyreek Hill, 17, Quentin Nelson, Jalen Ramsey, George Kittle, Travis Kelce, Josh Allen, the quarterback, Alvin Kamara,
Michael Thomas, Russell Wilson, Hopkins, Adams from the Packers, and Stephon Diggs is 6.
Run wide receivers.
So we have 5 players left in our top 100 off the
and
dome.
Obviously,
and we're going to forget several.
We're not going to forget. We're going
to we'll miss.
Deliberately know that we're missing people.
So Stephon Diggs was my pick.
Oh shit!
So number 5 is all you.
All right,
off the dome. Who's the 5th best player in the NFL?
I got it. He says.
This is how the segment goes. You know, we ponder.
Don't call me Christian.
Christian Ponder. If you know, you know.
Christian McCaffrey.
Okay. Christian McCaffrey. I can't spell right now. I'm 7 beers deep. I spelled Christob McCaffacat. Okay, number 4. I can't put this man any higher than 3, so I'm going to have to go Derrick Henry.
I like that. That's okay. Fine. Derrick Henry. We're obviously going to forget someone.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Number 3, give me...
Top 3 best players in the NFL is... Wonder who the audience has in their top 3. DT. Who the hell is DT?
Demaryius Thomas?
Demaryius Thomas. Who's DT? Oh.
Oh, well,
oh yeah.
That's...
We got him. We got him in our heads. Andy has 2 more players. I have 1. So he's got to come correct with his list.
So we're done with running backs.
Yeah, we should be. And we're done with them.
So we're quarterbacks and DT.
Yeah.
I think we're good. No, we're missing. We did the math last week. We're missing someone.
We're missing somebody. We'll figure that out later. We're not going to figure that out tonight. Got a lot in us.
I got two quarterbacks and a DT.
So do I, but like I'm sure we're missing somebody. Say it. We're getting there. We're getting there.
That's the whole point. Give us some time.
I don't know why he's taking so long when we have the players in our heads.
No, but there's someone that we're missing from.
We're missing like several players. Several. We get there when we get there.
And I can't think of it. So give me Aaron Donald.
Aaron Donald. I might have put him top 2. but it's your pick.
I know we're missing someone. I just can't think of him right now. So let's just roll with it. So we're doing two quarterbacks right here.
Aaron Rodgers.
And give me Patrick Mahomes. So who are we missing? No, we're not flipping that.
Yeah, we're not flipping that. Let's see.
We're missing someone. Who was it last week when we were talking about it? Yeah. Who was it?
I can't think of who we're missing. We're missing somebody out of this top 100 list.
Was it a wide receiver? Was it Julio? Oh, yeah, we don't have Julio.
Oh, we missed Julio again. We missed him last year, too. Oh. Why we hate him.
That's
Tucker. We missed Tucker. I think we might be good.
Are we good?
Is this
our best list?
Fuck y'all, we might be good.
Top 100 off the dome.
Top 100 successful wrap up. First 20 were god awful, but we did it. We didn't forget a damn person. Let's go. Until someone sees this and says, hey, you guys forgot this man.
What?
It's CM Punk.
Yeah, we have a. It's in my raves. It's coming
it's in
up.
My raves.
But I have to pee. Should I pee now?
No, you can hold it.
Okay. All right.
Yeah. Exactly.
So we have rants, raves, and reviews.
A lot of future kind of yelling right now.
And I know what's coming up. I'm gonna bring this up.
Go ahead.
OnlyFans. OnlyFans decided that they're not in the porn industry. Even though
Dad's here,
everyone knows them from the porn industry. Tell me how, why, when, what?
What?
Like, why did this happen? Tell me everything.
So, OnlyFans came under scrutiny because they were trying to find investors to invest in their company. Honestly.
I like how your dad's like pretending that's to like be busy.
He heard OnlyFans. He said, let me turn this back. I'm a Christian man. I'm a Christian man. But OnlyFans was trying to get investors in. They were like, yo, y'all are known for this pornography site. And I guess because OnlyFans wants to get these investors, wants to get these dollars, they said, hey, we're going to stop this sexually explicit content.
What else do they have?
They've got nothing. That's literally what their platform is known as, established as, and what has...
Are they not making enough money through that to turn down investors?
They've made $5 billion from creators over the past 2 years.
So why would they need to change what they're doing just for investors?
That's the question. That's the question. Everybody is questioning that.
Pigs get fat, hogs get slaughtered.
I don't know what that means, but...
Okay.
But... This story is a question amongst all SW workers.
What's that? SW?
Sexual workers.
Is that what you put on your
No, taxes? That's what they abbreviated as SW. But they said sexually explicit content is not allowed, but you still may post nude photos and videos as long as it is within the terms and conditions of the site, which have not been established yet by the platform. So this is all just a big confusing thing right now. But I think a lot of the people that establish themselves on OnlyFans are going to be looking towards another platform before they can determine what the fuck they're going to do with their future. But I think I'm good because I don't...
My question was going to be, are we going to be able to pay our rent?
I think we'll be able to pay our rent.
Your dad's laughing.
We're good this month in September. We'll have to wait and see what happens with the platform in October. I'll keep you guys updated on Dunn and Drew about what happens with OnlyFans. But I think with the...
am I going to have to get involved to up the price?
I mean, we could pay for 12 months of rent with you if you get involved. But
with one video?
Yeah, one. Shit. Give me like 10 videos will be good, but we'll see how that happens. It's a developing story, like the Taliban in Afghanistan.
Hey,
but
hey, hey, hey.
That's the second time I brought that up today. It ain't even politics. It's humanitarian crisis. But
why is this humanities?
But we'll see, man. We'll see what happens with OnlyFans. But it's devastating that they're trying to divert away from what made them a platform in the first place. So. And I'm a victim, but
you're a victim. All right, my rave is CM Punk's debut in AEW.
Hey, Dad, do you watch wrestling?
No.
Are you into it at all?
No.
Ever have been?
Can we talk wrestling? All right. Oh. I found someone in the audience. I haven't talked to him yet. He's actually wearing the same Trevor Lawrence jersey that I have. Jersey. So, have you seen me in his video where we react to...
Yeah, he saw it. He said it was a great review.
You knew everything about it?
So,
I tried.
You did?
Yeah. We'll start off by saying it was taken down by AEW Wrestling. They did a copyright strike.
They gave us a YouTube strike.
AEW did a sweeping copyright strike with every video that reacted to AEW last night because they understood what the moment was.
Yeah.
They know that people will be searching this for the next
6 million views.
20 years.
How many views you would get for that?
We had 10K views
when it got taken down at 4 hours.
4 hours?
Yeah. It got taken down at like 4 or 5 a.m. And I checked CM Punk to see, I searched CM Punk on YouTube to see all the other reaction videos. None of them that I watched earlier that day were up anymore. They took all of them down, and AEW's video had 2 million views because they won all that fucking
engagement.
They were
trending number 1, 5, 23.
Easily.
Yeah.
65, they were trending all night long.
It was a huge moment that I didn't know.
You didn't fully grasp because you wouldn't live it.
I didn't fully grasp because I'm not a wrestling fan. I didn't watch back when he wrestled, but I understood the moment. And I understood why AEW would take it down.
You love that Jordan-esque comment by JR?
Oh, my God.
That was perfect.
The whole commentary, the whole setup of him, to have him come out, give him, like, 10 minutes to just say things.
It felt like 30.
It was...
What, 19, 18 minutes?
Perfect.
Total? Yeah.
It was so perfect. Where were you watching? From your couch?
Couch, yep.
Yep, same.
And were you 100% confident that he was going to come out?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
No,
I mean, they would get murdered for
that. What made you guys feel like CM Punk was coming out? Because they didn't ever say his name or anything.
They dropped hints.
Yeah. The hints were too obvious.
Was it 2 weeks ago with Darby Allin?
Yes.
In the promo he had, he said, if you're the best in the world, come prove it. Some of that. Yeah. And the whole audience knew.
Everyone
what was
knew.
Going on.
Yeah.
And they cut cameras to fans cheering CM Punk.
And for Tony Khan to pull up a appearance in Chicago, spontaneously, mm-hmm. they wouldn't do that unless they had CM Punk.
Tony Khan's smart.
To sell out the whole arena just under the rumors. The rumors, strong rumors, but just rumors that he was going to be there. I knew that he had to come out first. Is that what you thought?
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah.
The crowd was so lit.
So hot. They were just about to, riot almost.
It was it was like the WWE crowd.
It was a tame riot.
Yeah, tame riot. Yeah.
It was like the WWE crowd when they went to Chicago, when they were hot
Money
for
bank.
CM Punk.
Money in the Bank.
Yeah. It was a Raw because Paul Heyman came out with, it was before the WrestleMania with Brock Lesnar versus Undertaker. I don't know if you saw Paul Heyman's explanation of what happened.
Didn't he come out to his music? And they were like, oh.
CM Punk's music hit in Chicago.
Yep.
Paul Heyman came out.
Cut a promo.
Yeah, cut a promo.
He's not here.
Yeah. Not here. But it's 7 years. No one has, he's gained popularity through that 7 years.
They changed his name.
From not being there
every
at all.
Every WWE show where they hate what's going on in the ring. They chant CM Punk because
they
know
chant his
going.
Name in WWE.
Yep.
Yes.
Still do.
If it's a boring match.
Yep.
If management is in the ring.
Yep.
They chant CM Punk.
That's why the AEW thing was so huge because they're about to take so many WWE fans and bring them over to AEW.
Some that were just not watching. They tuned in just for that.
Yeah. Yes. And how WWE's been around forever, right?
Ever.
And AEW is 2 years old. They're about to destroy them. And I don't know how long it's going to take, but it's coming.
They destroyed NXT on when they went back.
I remember NXT. I remember that, but I haven't even heard of that.
They moved them to Friday nights.
Oh my
God. What was your reaction when you came out? Were you vocal? Were you just internalized it?
I kept turning the TV, the volume up.
Volume
on the TV.
Up.
I
saw
you doing your video. I was like
volume up, volume up.
I was like, this, because it's the perfect song. I was like, if you didn't have that song also,
it probably would have been different.
Yeah,
and people in our TikTok comment, because he did a TikTok clip. I don't know if you saw that, but
100,000 views.
People in our TikTok comments were saying how Andy was really relaxed, but it's he knew that it was coming, so he had to grasp the moment.
A lot of my feelings were internalized. Like, yeah. I was the whole 7 years of, you know, we had a lot of rumors in WWE, like, oh, could CM Punk be here at this pay-per-view? Mm-hmm. Like, we had a lot of moments in WWE where we're, like, expecting him, kind of. Not really, but, hoping. Like, hoping. Yeah, hoping. Yeah, a lot of hope, but yeah. it never came through, yeah, which yeah. I'm glad, because he doesn't need to be in WWE.
I mean, a lot of perfect storms lately. Yeah. I was saying it was a big moment because it was his hometown, and he's been away from wrestling for 7 years, and it's a new... What is it? What do you call it? A league?
No, this is a promotion.
Promotion.
Oh, promotion? Yeah. Okay. Still learning.
I mean, you see the guy was crying. Tomato my biz. In the crowd. So.
Yes.
People still care.
Yeah.
That rivals, you know, the Undertaker meme.
Oh, where the guy's.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Just straight at.
Yeah, that's going to go down in history.
And like, apparently Tony Khan and them are giving that guy tickets to the next show.
Of course. Because
they're like, he has heart for this. Yes. He cares crying. About this. Yeah, crying yeah. about it. And then crowd surfing, like, you know, you can't do that in a different city. Awesome.
No,
you,
really? You no, Chicago. I love how he said Darby Allin. Mm. I love how he called out Darby Allin, obviously, because Darby Allin called at him pretty much. Yeah. That's going to be an awesome match.
That's going to be
awesome
crazy. Match. Staying out there.
Yeah.
CM Punk getting coffin dropped.
That's gonna be the first wrestling pay-per-view that I buy. I try
to drop a little knowledge in.
I like that coffee.
Yeah, all right.
Knees to faces, though. GTS.
GTS.
Darby's going to sleep.
I'm lost.
Go to sleep.
I'm lost.
Go to sleep.
They countered.
Anyway,
well, y'all got me.
He's not taking that L. First match.
He can't take an L.
Can't take that L.
But the fact that he has Darby, like, you're putting Darby over by wrestling him as your first match.
He's going to have. They're going to have a 5-star match with that thing.
Yeah. First match back in 7 years. That's enough for Darby, but CM Punk's winning.
Yeah.
Of course, he's going to help a lot of the talent.
Yeah, get better. He even rub. Said it that he wants to help the younger.
Yeah,
like,
he's going
to
get the rub. He even brought out Britt Baker's name the first thing he said.
He did.
Oh yeah.
So he's going to go for it.
Pee.
Right.
Like that.
Okay.
All right.
Appreciate you on the pod, man.
Sir.
Yes. Thank you.
I love you.
What's your name?
Dustin.
Dustin. Yeah. Cheers,
from
Dustin.
Jax. Yes, sir.
Go Jags, baby.
Go Jags.
That's why we all here.
I'll tell you this.
CM Punk, my rave.
You got another one here.
Yes, our TikTok game, but I already touched on it.
Yeah,
we're killing it.
We are. I got a lot to rave about. Here, I'm just going to list them off real quick for y'all. We've also talked about this, but our best episode last week with Jackson DeVille, the mascot.
Are you calling it our best episode?
It is. It was. It was well received. All the 200 episodes, the last one was most received, well received. And like you said, over 1.5 million views on TikToks from the clips from it.
But probably 2 million.
Also, I secured a five-figure bag for an IG campaign. Five figures, so it could be 10K.
Including the decimal?
It could be 10K to 99K. I ain't going to tell you. Hey, securing bags this fall. I got 2 video shoots this week, Wednesday and Thursday. One's a testimonial vid for a company that I've worked with previously on a Jaguars campaign. And the other one is for NASCAR on Thursday. I'm shooting for NBC digital content and TV. It'll be on TV, like a cut of it will be on TV. So it's going to be a busy week after this pod. And we're interviewing Josh Scobie on Monday night.
Let's hear for Josh Scobie.
Josh Scobie! Hey, Steelers fans, y'all had him for like 4 games. And he didn't do nothing for you, but he did everything for us. So, he wasn't on the Chargers, chill.
Flamingo
my last
shirt.
Rave is that we will be at the Coke Zero 400 next Saturday night. The last NASCAR race of the season. I don't think Andy's ever been to a NASCAR race, have you?
No, sir. Well, the 24 hours, is that NASCAR?
No, it's not. So
all right, then no.
You've never been to a NASCAR
race?
Even
though I was born in Daytona.
Been born in Daytona. His dad
is a NASCAR writer.
Covers NASCAR, and he's never been to a race. Never been to a race. I'm taking him
boogity,
next
boogity,
Saturday.
Boogity.
Next Saturday, we're going to the Coke Zero.
Here, you got to do it.
Boogity, boogity,
no.
Boogity. Oh.
Well,
if it isn't the day Turner Fairbanny.
Even though it's a Coke Zero 400. But we'll be there next Saturday. We'll be in the suites. Ugly ass boy ain't done.
Ugly ass boy.
Is Bubba Wallace going to finish top 10?
No, he's not. But it's going to be a good time next Saturday. But we got a lot ahead of us this next week. And that is a wrap on episode 200, boy. Let's go. Hey, share this episode with your friends, parents, enemies. Rate and review us on Apple Podcasts. Share this show with, I already said that. I'm tanked, all right? I'm about to finish this beer. Subscribe to Patreon. Subscribe to YouTube. We'll see you next time. This has been Dunn and Drew, baby.
Tip your bartenders.
Eat some nuts.